Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Banging Donuts with Mr. Kristopher. I'm Vinny Bag of Donuts.
I'm Bangs Michael.
I am Fabulous Kristopher.
Yes, he's fabulous.
Fucking fabulous. Get the fuck out of here. I'm a rock star, guys.
Well, I hope everyone's doing all right. This is our first show in 2 weeks. We took last week off for the holidays, Christmas and Hanukkah and all that good stuff, because we all celebrate everything here. And a little bit of nothing. So let's start out there. Bangs, Chris, how was your guys' Christmas? Or
You go first,
Hanukkah,
Chris.
or yeah, whatever.
Okay. So let's see. What did I get for Christmas? I got a new webcam, so I look beautiful. That's why the sunglasses. I'm really trying to rock it out. I got Suicide Squad on DVD, which I for one liked that movie. I don't know what you guys think about it, but
I haven't seen it.
Yeah, I haven't
you
seen it.
have not seen the movie.
I tried
I had
watching
it
it the other day. It
Batman
was a shit.
screen yet.
Yeah, it was a shitty copy. Batman Superman, we just don't watch the first hour of it and just watch the second hour. It's good.
Just skip ahead of the second hour.
Yeah, the first hour is atrocious.
I got that's I think that's all I got for Christmas, but I had a good time. I had family hanging around, and yeah,
It's
real
fascinating.
uneventful actually. Yeah,
Very
fascinating. I
fascinating.
know, right? Great radio.
What about you, Banks?
We try to keep Christmas chill. I did the thing at my mom's. We just like make a bunch of snacks and hang out, and I guess the Seahawks played, so I watched that atrocity of a game. And then that was Christmas Eve, and then Christmas Day, I go to my in-laws and sit around all day just waiting for dinner to be done. And we had rules about no gifts this year, which of course the moms all broke. So we had to do
Oh,
presents, except that we didn't bring
yeah.
anything. So, then I'm already on the shit list around town anyway. So then I felt like a huge ass because I didn't bring anything. Yeah, I got some stuff. I don't know.
What do you mean you're on the shit list? What's going on?
Oh, I'm always on my in-law shit list for something. Fucking,
Yeah.
Do they not like you?
No.
Is it
But
because
that's
you're
not
off?
new. That's not new.
How stereotypical of you? That's like every movie. The in-laws hate me.
Oh, yeah. Well, not all the in-laws, just the ones here. The ones in your neck of the woods, Chris, they love me. So it's
Oh,
just,
okay.
yeah, it's not all the in-laws, just some of them.
What?
I freaking
The
live
in-laws and
with
his?
my mother-in-law and her boyfriend and their
Yeah, you can't
daughter.
fuck around because that's a, that's a, it's a,
Yeah, you better
if
like your
you,
in-laws.
yeah, I was saying,
Yeah, right.
if you don't mind me getting a little personal,
That's fine.
that's an interracial, relationship. You don't want to piss them off. You don't want to
What
fuck
does
around.
that? What does interracial have to do with pissing them
If
off?
we're
Well, it
getting
won't be because you don't like
stereotypical.
her, it's because you're a racist.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, so wait, the mom is white,
right?
Okay. The boyfriend
Well,
is very
I would
black.
think your mom was, her
Very
mom was
black.
white.
Oh. No, not my, well, Ona's mom is white. Okay.
Yeah, well, I would think so, considering your wife is white.
Yeah, well well, and Ona's sister is half black.
Oh, okay.
And
Was that like
Yeah,
a
what
was
is
that a Kermit the Frog that's none of my business sip? What was that?
why is this
I'm
this is
drinking soda, dude.
this is getting very edgy right
Half
now.
black.
I feel like we need to bring a black guy on the show now. We need to find
Look,
one.
Hitler was a bad guy. All I'm saying is he had some
No, he's a
ideas.
great guy. No, the Jeff, my mother-in-law's boyfriend, is a great guy. Very
I'm sure
giving,
it
very
is. Is that
I
Ona's
didn't.
sister's dad?
No,
Oh.
he's there's no marriage, there's just a boyfriend
I didn't say
of
anything about
the
marriage. I was talking about offspring.
Oh no, that guy's an asshole.
What? That
Ona's
never
sister's dad.
happens.
Yeah, I know, right? He's a real piece of work. And if I ever saw him, I would
You wouldn't do shit. I'll just. You have
no
better words
no
for him.
you know what? I look better with the glasses on. I don't I'm gonna put them back on.
Are those
Thank you.
like your invisible glasses? We can't see you now.
Yeah. It's like, no, you can't see me.
I was watching Big Daddy the other day. Oh.
I don't remember seeing that movie. I might have seen it, but
That was one of the first DVDs I owned. I got a DVD player 1 year for Christmas, speaking of, and my mom just bought me like five random DVDs. That was one of
it's like one of the dollar
them.
dollar DVD.
No, back then that was probably a $25 DVD. You had to
Oh,
go to Circuit
really?
City. Yeah, you had to go to Circuit City. They had like all the DVDs were expensive.
Oh,
And
Circuit City, man.
it's like
it
when
was all
Blu-rays.
DivX. Yeah, you remember DivX where you'd like pay $5 and you'd rent the DVD, but you had 24, it had some sort of DRM on it. You had 24 hours to watch it. And then if you wanted to keep it, you could pay the rest. Your DVD had to have internet access or something. I don't remember. I never did it,
What?
but it would unlock the DRM or something.
Dude, that's still kind of like that. Like if you rent, you can rent something on like on demand, and it's like $3 or five to $5, and it's like you 24
Right.
hours to watch it.
Right.
It's like, what the fuck? Remember you go to
What the
Blockbuster,
fuck?
rent a movie for a week.
Yeah.
The days of
Well,
Blockbuster.
guess who's still in business and who's not in business? So maybe
Well,
Blockbuster should have.
should have gone online.
You also have unlimited fucking. It's not like you can only stream. You can oh I can we can only rent out four copies of this on demand.
Yeah. Yeah. Redbox got it figured out. It's $1 a day.
Yeah.
So you rent it thinking, oh, it's only going to be a dollar. And then 3 weeks later.
I never used it. I've
I
used it
haven't
like
either.
once. They do video games now, and that just doesn't seem worth it. It's expensive as shit.
Is it?
Yeah. I'm waiting for like porn mobile like that.
Why
would you go to a Redbox to get
what?
porn?
I don't know. It
Dude,
just sounds
there's
cool.
so much free porn, dude. Come
Well,
on.
no, not I. Well, I would watch it there and masturbate on the street corner. Yeah.
He'd have his portable DVD player on the
Yeah,
corner,
just pop it
sitting on the curb, just watching,
I would just to keep.
just jacking.
I'll
I
just
used to
keep exchanging movies on the
back
Redbox.
in the day when I went to a gym. There, this is gonna hear me out on this. This has nothing to do with porn, but there was a guy who had a little portable DVD player, and I was always on the elliptical machine. He was always on the recumbent bike, so he'd be sitting right in front of me, and I, he's down low and I'm up high. And he always had his portable DVD player. And there was like 3 months where I watched the first season or maybe first 2 seasons of Star Trek Enterprise because he was working his way through it on the bike, just watching it over his shoulder. Couldn't hear anything, had no dialogue, but I watched
Oh,
the
that chick in
I'm sure
Star
it was
Trek
gripping.
Enterprise was so hot. I don't remember her
Oh, the
name.
Vulcan chick?
Oh yeah, she was just
Yeah.
so fucking sexy. When they had to go into the decontamination chamber.
Oh, right.
Oh
She was, yeah,
God.
she was hot. She was a hot commodity there for a minute.
Yeah,
I
I
don't know what
looked her
happened to
up.
her after, but
Very cunty, but
is she?
yeah, but she was cool.
So I'm looking at our pictures. Okay, so Bangs's picture. He's basically got an extension of his hat that it looks like a party favor that's exploding.
We
No,
could
yeah.
fix that. It's supposed to be.
And Vinny, you're hiding some dude's junk,
So,
basically, with your
yeah, is
head.
there a problem with
No,
that?
Vinny's head is the guy's junk. It's a metaphor.
Oh,
It's a metaphor.
It's a
it's a
metaphor.
metaphor. You're just one big testicle.
I'm
That's
one
the.
big dick on a ginger's body. No, it's my uncle. It's my uncle Diddles.
That a noun or a verb? Uncle
Yeah, she didn't do
Diddles.
shit besides Star Trek. Jeez. Sorry, I'm on the
No,
hot Vulcan
but
chick.
she's hot though, right?
Yeah, I'm
You
not mad
wish
at
you were
her.
on her.
I'm not mad at her.
God, I look like I'm
Big fake
hungover.
tits.
Looking at the picture.
I don't have a
Yeah,
problem
whatever.
with
Taryn, why
So
would
what's
you give my
going
beard
on?
a 7 of 9? Who goes out of 9? Why wouldn't that be out
No,
of
no, no.
10?
7 of 9 was a character. She's talking
Ah.
about 7 of 9 from Voyager.
I didn't watch
Jerry Voyager,
Yeah.
the super hot blonde,
Oh, I didn't
who
watch
whose husband
Voyager.
was a senator that went to sex dungeons. You should know all about this, Vinny.
Oh, well, I never watched Voyager. All I read was her first comment said everyone's beard's looking awesome. Then I see 7 of 9 though, Vin. Like what are you talking about? No, I didn't watch Voyager. I watched the original series because that's the best and Enterprise. I couldn't get
You
into
don't.
Next Generation.
Oh,
What?
no, Next Gen's
What's
way better.
wrong with
Next
you?
Gen's better than the original.
Here's the thing though. I don't love Star Trek. I like Star Trek, don't get me wrong, but I don't love it based on
Okay.
like the myth. I just love how perfectly shitty it is, like the original series was. Like William
Gotcha.
Shatner just fucking up every line. Like I loved it. I love the
Yeah.
pure shit of it. So the new movies I think are awesome though. I
Yeah.
thoroughly enjoy them.
Although I haven't seen the most recent one, so
It was good.
I
I
don't think
watched
I
it
have either,
last week. It was very good. Chick's very hot in it. The one who plays
though.
she plays I don't know, she's like white with like black tats or something like that. I don't know.
I don't know.
Like pit like white, not white skin, like she's white.
No, I got you. Alien. She's white.
She's white.
Oh, very she's hot. An alien.
Yeah, she's an alien.
Okay. She's a white alien.
I looked her up, though. She's not as hot in real life. the paint really does it.
What? Makeup?
What was the name of that? Star Trek what?
Into the Beyond. Darkness. Oh, no, Beyond. Yeah, Into Darkness was the middle one.
This is a great podcast. I'm spending this whole time looking shit up.
Yeah, we're getting very excited. Well, like, yeah. We're not even talking about anything.
I mean, if you were looking it up for like show content, that's one thing. But you're
I don't know the characters' names, so I'm just looking up all of the hot chicks and seeing.
This is what the show is now. We talk about hot chicks and look them up. You guys can't see them.
And Google them.
Yeah, well, we Google them and rate them.
I'm sure the audience is Googling them too. We're all Googling.
I highly doubt it.
She's not aight.
No. In real life, she's
aight.
Wait, who are you looking at?
I don't know. Anita Brown.
I don't know who that is.
She played T'Vanna.
Is that the one in white? When she's in white, when she's in makeup.
I don't have her in full Star Trek makeup.
It's Star Trek makeup. She's hotter than she is in real life. Is what I'm trying to say.
Okay, well, this chick's hot in real life too.
Most people are like porn stars. I mean, come on.
Porn stars are usually disgusting in real life.
Yeah. Oh, you're talking about the other way around.
Yeah,
I guess it'd help if I listened to you.
Yeah. Zoe Saldana.
Take your sunglasses off so you can hear us.
Ridiculously hot.
What? Yeah. I'm keeping them on. I look so much sexier with them on. That's what I think.
You do. I'm spreading wood right now.
I'm looking at it. Like, it looks like I have a big chrome penis that's jutting out of my lap.
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
No, I'm looking at the microphone. It's whatever.
See if you can suck your own dick. Good job.
So when I send you the video of that.
That's not sucking, but.
When I send you the video of that to turn into a GIF, that's going to be all right, right?
You're just going
to have a problem with that?
No, I don't authorize that at all.
Oh, so there are limits to what you're willing to do.
I'm big time now. You got to pay royalties for that.
Christopher is big time now, son of a bitch.
It's all about working.
Through no fault of my own. I don't know.
Well, anyway, my Christmas was okay, guys.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. How are you doing?
Whatever.
No, it was right. Christmas Eve is more bigger in my family because it's a very Italian thing. So I go to my dad's, and we had some family come down from North Jersey who very old school Italian who they usually don't spend Christmas Eve with us, but they came down this year. And it was real nice. You know, you do the fishes, the seven fishes and all that stuff. We cheat a little bit. We go a lot of shellfish, which you're not supposed to do. But dessert was great. Very old school Italian desserts, homemade, which was very awesome. Reminded me of when I was younger, when my grandparents were alive, and, you know, going to their house and all that stuff. But Christmas Day was fun. We spent with my nieces, and they had a great Christmas. It was more fun. You know, you're older now, so it's whatever. But still seeing kids at that young age, you know, they're like 4 and 6 who still believe in Santa, and watching them Christmas morning, you know, Santa came and the presents, it's you know, you get feelings. It was nice, you know. I did get some gift cards though, and I got like from the family, like combined, like I got some other things, but I got gift cards, like about $150 worth of gift cards, and I didn't know what to do with them. I didn't want to know if I just wanted to buy games or I want to upgrade some of my shit. Like I want to upgrade my monitor. They're just generic Visa cards.
Oh, okay.
I got $275 ones, and I want a new monitor because I know some of my games look like shit. But then I was thinking maybe if Nintendo announces that they're gonna actually take, or maybe stores actually take pre-orders for a fucking change of Nintendo, maybe I'll dump that. You know, that's probably half of the Switch right now on the pre-order of the Switch.
So I heard it's like $250 for the base and $300 for the super model.
The pro, yeah, that's kind of what we predicted back in September. So I'm looking at the calendar. The event's on the 13th, so we should know more
which we'll be doing a show that night on the Switch. We'll be doing a Bang and Down show on that. The fuck are we talking about?
2016.
Oh
yeah, 2016 sucked ass, like everybody knows, and we're all keeping our head down for another 24 hours and hoping we make it through, because we arbitrarily assigned time to the spinning of the earth.
Do we think anyone's going to die within the next 24 hours?
I mean, lots of people are going to die.
Well, I meant like, yeah, I mean, come on. Come on. Don't be a dick.
So, someone important.
Did he just, did Vinny Bag of Donuts just tell somebody not to be a dick?
Whatever. What if, this is real dark, but what if Carrie Fisher's daughter dies?
Oh, fuck.
Oh, come on.
Is her daughter somebody?
She was in the new Star Wars. She's trying to be an actress. She's pretty hot, actually. You know, that's all I focus
on. Hold
on,
I gotta look.
Watch your Google that, man. She's not bad looking. She a cutie. She's young too. She's like 24.
Oh, look. Like okay. So I'm in Google and I got Carrie Fisher out, and the first thing that popped up was Carrie Fisher daughter.
Oh yeah, everyone's looking her up. Whoa, what? Dude, okay. You know how fucking all traumatic right. I gotta Google that the now. Last like week has been for her. You lose your mother and your grandmother within fucking 48 hours. That's some fucked
she's
up
on
shit.
Scream Queens. That's a big show.
Yeah, she growing. She's sexy. Yeah. Right?
She's okay.
Yeah, she's all right. She's a little young looking for me.
You know, looking at these pictures of really, really old Carrie Fisher looks like what's her name? Kylie. What's her name with the fucking transgender girl?
Wait. Okay. Stop. Hold on. First of all,
Bruce Jenner.
Okay. The old Kylie picture looks like
Kylie.
Like, huh? No, Caitlyn. You're talking the daughter. Caitlyn. One of the kids' name is Kyle or Kaylee or Carl. Yeah, I don't know.
Whatever but, she yes. turned into.
Yes,
Bruce. Am I right?
Caitlyn Jenner.
Yeah, I can see that in some of these photos. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, Carrie Fisher had some miles under her, so you know
she was fucking sexy. Yeah, she back in the Star Wars. Days.
That's how she got the miles under her. Everyone was feeding her pills and.
I love how she fucked Harrison Ford, or how they fucked on set.
Did she?
She wrote in her book that they had an affair on a set, and he didn't deny it.
Yeah.
He's older than her, too. God, to be Harrison Ford in his prime.
And he was married at the time.
Yeah, well, why would that stop you? That wouldn't stop me.
A 19-year-old Carrie Fisher? Is my wife watching? Yes, she is. No, that wouldn't stop me.
No, I don't think she'd blame me.
if I'm Harrison Ford, it ain't stopping me.
No.
Look, I told my wife she could bang the Thor guy, whatever his name is.
Yeah, I don't know. Hemsworth?
Yeah. She's got a crush on him. I'm like, okay, fine. You could bang him.
Yeah, that's her, too.
That's her celebrity card?
Yeah, that's her celebrity one.
What's your celebrity card? Is it China still? Is it China?
It's no, Chris Hemsworth.
No, I like
Chris Hemsworth.
We're both gonna. Bang.
They're gonna double like up double on team. Chris Hemsworth.
Yeah. I'm gonna jack him off into her mouth. I guess.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Well played, sir. Well played.
This sounds like something I would
Good
say.
Job.
Jesus Christ, Chris. But if we're being honest with each
remember
other,
remember when Chris was the butt of the jokes and not the one slinging them? Jesus, he doesn't need us for anything anymore.
But if we're being completely honest with each other, she'd be jerking him off into your mouth.
Fair, that's fair.
You'd go ask the mouth.
I'm not judging. This is a safe space, judgment free.
All right, Chris.
Wait.
Chris Hemsworth or Chris Evans?
Oh.
Or Chris Pine.
Or Chris, ooh.
Oh, who's the
a young
guy
Captain
with,
Kirk?
So Chris Pine is Captain Kirk. Chris Evans is Captain
I want to play this guy with the fucking dinosaurs. What's his name?
What? Chris
Pratt?
Pratt, yeah.
Yeah, I'll fuck him.
With the dinosaurs. He's like, stay back.
Dude, I remember watching him on dinosaurs. Parks and Recreation. Park and Recreations, and he was like, he was a little chubbier and stuff.
Yeah, well, he got ripped for Guardians, and you're like,
yeah.
You motherfucker, you're making me look bad.
He surpassed his wife so fucking fast. She must be, I don't know, maybe she's jealous. Yeah. I can see her being jealous.
I don't know.
Like, I was just looking up Parks and Recs, and I don't think this is the right show.
With Amy Poehler.
Oh, fuck.
Parks and Recreation?
No, that's not the right show that I'm looking for.
The fuck are you looking up?
Are you talking about Chris
Pratt? No, you're talking about, my celebrity crush chick, and I know you guys are talking about dudes, but...
You're looking here.
Is there anything else to be talking about?
Riff Tanks in the chat wants to throw Chris Angel into the ring.
Chris
Angel,
I don't know.
Know who that. He's like a magician or something, right?
Yeah, he's like a magician. He's not a very good one. He's a very popular one, but he's not a very good one.
I'm looking up. I forget her name.
How do you not know the names of the women you want to sleep with?
Because I'm never gonna meet them. Okay, starring. Shit.
What show?
Well, she was in Scott Pilgrim versus the World. Not the head chick, but the one that was the. She was just like a side chick with the black hair. God, the
Yeah, I
name,
don't
her
know who she
name.
is either.
I don't know.
God
But you're
damn
dragging
it.
us down, Chris.
Yeah, I'm
really.
dragging. I'll, you know what? Once you guys start talking about something else, I'm gonna know the name.
No, I'm gonna have it figured out for you well ahead of time because my
I
wife
fuck.
can't remember anybody's name either. Is it Allison Pill?
No.
She's good. She's a looker.
Olivia
It's
Wilde.
Olivia
No,
Wilde's a
but
looker.
I'm looking at the fucking Wikipedia page and it's not showing her name. God
Anna
damn it.
Kendrick's a looker.
No, she,
I don't
this
think her
girl's not a
nose. Jesus fucking
looker.
every hot chick in this movie was. Why was this movie so shitty? Allison Pill,
What?
Ellen Wong,
What?
Anna
That movie's
Kendrick, Aubrey Plaza.
fucking Aubrey Plaza, I love her.
Oh, she's also in
Well,
Parks and Rec.
yeah. Why can't you just go to Park? You motherfucker! You brought us all the way around here.
Son of
Yeah.
a bitch, we're right back to Aubrey to Parks and Rec.
You could
It's
have just went on
funny
that
'cause I was looking
IMDb.
up. Yeah, I can get you with Aubrey Plaza. Okay. I fucking
Yeah.
love that woman. I will.
I mean, if I, she's not Anna Kendrick, but all right.
See, I like
Whatever.
her better than Anna Kendrick. I don't like
I
Anna
mean,
Kendrick's
well, good.
nose.
Anne and I will be very happy together while you two fight over Aubrey.
Well, Aubrey, like, if I want to be, like, she plays that character so well that, like, you definitely hire her to be some,
What are you doing?
bondage and stuff.
What? Stop.
I'm doing my daily show, my once a show thing.
I want to fuck Kathy Bates for the story.
Kathy
Okay,
Bates.
now, Chris, never mind. Go back to
Wrinkly
your straw. This took a turn.
old pussy. Kathy
Yeah,
Bates.
but think about this
Is it, you
story.
know what? Just because of that, Kathy Bates won't make it to 2017.
She's
The
a menacing
universe is
hunter.
not going to allow that statement to rest.
All these people thought,
Wrinkly
you know
old
who's
pussy.
still going strong? Fucking Sean Connery.
Yeah, well,
Oh,
he spent
yeah.
all those years banging Bond girls,
And Don Rickles.
and he probably still is. You know what? Speaking of Don Rickles, so we saw he had that documentary a couple years ago. I don't remember what it was called. Miss, Mr.
Mr.
Yeah,
Warmth?
Mr.
Mr.
Wonderful, yeah, or
Warmth.
something like
No,
that.
Mr. Warmth. Yeah. Yeah, I
Mr.
like
Warmth,
that. That was
yeah,
good.
and I've been a big fan of his for a while, but I watched that documentary and absolutely, it took my fandom to this whole other level, and Taryn watched it with me and she loved it. And so we're like, God, next time we're in Vegas, we should try to see Don Rickles. Oh, it'd be so great to see Don Rickles. And then, like 2 months later, I see a pop-up that he's going to be here
Oh, wow.
doing a show. And I spent like $150 a piece on tickets. It was at the casino, so we went out and had, nice dinner and all this other shit. We spent like $500 probably that all in, for this whole thing.
Wow.
And I'm thinking that this can be the last time there's he's he, A, he ain't coming around no more, and B, he'll probably not make it through the end of the year because he was barely getting around then. And that son of a bitch has held on for like another 10 years,
Yeah.
and he's come back six times. And I was so fucking broke when we went to that show. I didn't have two nickels to rub
Yeah,
together, but I got it together because I'm like, you know what? I'll make money tomorrow, but Don Rickles won't be here tomorrow. This son
well,
of a bitch is still here.
at least you could say you still saw him, though. Like, I never seen him. Like, I bought tickets when
It
he was
was
in Atlantic
great.
City. He was in Atlantic City. I bought tickets for my mom, and she said he was
Oh,
fantastic.
he killed it. He was so good, and it was so vaudeville too, because he'd dance and he'd do a little soft shoe shuffle, and then he'd like stop the song and call somebody a kike, and then he'd go right back into
Yeah.
his little dance.
What?
Well,
Yeah,
Don
no, I'm
Rickles,
not joking.
that's that's
I'm
well,
not
no,
joking.
that's
He's
his act.
super. Yeah,
Like,
and then for us locally, there was the guy. There was a guy 2 rows in front of us. You guys, he does a lot of national commercial voiceover stuff, but there's this local guy named Pat Cashman. He's super famous locally. He's done local radio. There was a TV show here called Almost Live that ran before Saturday Night Live for like 20 years. It was on Comedy Central for a while, like a huge local show where they just make fun of everything in Western Washington. It's so funny, but he was big on that. And he was sitting two rows in front of us. So prior to Don Rickles coming out, Pat Cashman was like the biggest thing going on right now. It was so funny watching all these people, walking up and trying to talk to him. And so it was like two shows in one. It was great. But you guys don't know who
Yeah.
Pat Cashman is, so it doesn't fucking
No.
matter.
But no, it's I get
But
what you're
he died though,
saying.
right?
Who?
He's on the
Don
list.
Rickles? No, he's still fucking alive. Or are you talking
No,
about
the
Pat
other guy,
Cashman?
the
He better
Pat
be
guy.
alive. Pat Cashman? No,
Oh.
Pat Cashman's alive.
I don't
How
fucking
dare
know,
you?
man.
Pat Cashman is a national treasure.
I don't know who the fuck that is, okay?
He's got a Wikipedia, I'll tell you that.
So I
Well,
have a Wikipedia.
we can make a Wikipedia
Do
for this
you
show.
really? I'm like, you son of a bitch. If you have a Wikipedia, I quit.
We should wait.
I quit the show. I quit fucking Twitch. I quit it all. If Chris gets a Wikipedia, I'm done.
We should make one. We should make one for this page.
Yeah, we're going to make
for
one
show.
Now.
Let's make one for this show.
What?
Banging donuts.
Pat Cashin was the narrator in Super Smash Bros. Brawl. He was the voice of Master Hand.
Fuck is Master Hand?
He's the
Is he your hand that just goes around and masturbates all the characters?
No. So the story of Super Smash Brothers is that they're amiibos, basically. This is like before amiibos, but they're little statues on stands, right? And it's basically a kid like banging them together, forcing them to fight the way a kid would. And that's why you have Mario and Donkey Kong fighting. And so when you play through the game and you get to the end, there's literally a floating like a Mickey Mouse hand. It's just a floating hand that you have to fight. And that's Master Hand. And he apparently does the voice of Master Hand.
That sounds stupid.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
he also did a bunch of stuff on Bill Nye, the Science Guy. He was the narrator on Bill Nye the Science Guy as well, actually, because Bill Nye was also got started on Almost Live. So if you're one of these millennials who talks about, oh, I love Bill Nye the Science Guy, that was my childhood, well, fucking go watch Almost Live, because that's where it started.
I remember Bill Nye on Saturday mornings, but I never really got into it. He would just be on.
Well, by then it was, if it was on Saturday mornings, by then Disney had bought out the show and they were screwing with it. When it was on PBS, it was amazing.
What the fuck are you doing, Chris?
He's singing Bill Nye the Science Guy.
What's the problem? You got a problem with me, sir?
Yeah.
Our problem is that your channel is blowing up and we're sitting here.
It's not. It's so fucking not, dude.
And you're tearing me apart, Lisa.
Am I kicking you in the balls?
The world is kicking me in the balls. Joel McHale. You guys know who Joel McHale is? He started on Almost Live. Suck it.
And Master Science 3000. Right?
What? No. That's Joel Hodgson. Joel McHale's on. He did Talks, or not Talk Soup.
Talk Soup. Soup. No, yeah.
And then he also did Community. Yeah.
I know who you're talking about now. My bad. Fuck it. I thought you were trying to be obscure.
Nope.
Who died? There's a lot of people fucking died. That's fucking the
died.
Thing.
A lot of people died.
2016 is a fucking
death. It's a year of death. Everyone's dead. It's going to be one hell of an in memoriam. And during the Oscars and shit.
Not so much because at this point you'll notice that the Oscars leave out half the people that died.
They only
cover the super famous people.
Well, there's a few super famous people that fucking died. Well, the Grammys will be big. There's a lot.
Yeah.
A lot of big names.
Well, it'll be Carrie Fisher and Debbie Reynolds for sure. And they'll probably Prince will be on all of them.
David Bowie.
Alan Rickman, David Bowie.
Let's see.
That's probably your top five there.
George Michael.
Abe Vigoda.
George Michael.
Abe Vigoda.
Fuck you, Chris. You didn't know who Abe Vigoda was 20 minutes ago.
So I fucking know now for the show. I did my research.
Don't drop his. Don't name drop Abe Vigoda died. Vigoda. I couldn't believe it. I was so shocked.
You
didn't even know who he was.
Can you name one movie he was in, Chris?
I had to explain.
Godfather.
Well, that's right there. Can you name a second one?
Vinny, do you know why? Because before you came on, he said, "Who's Abe Vigoda?" And I explained to him who Abe Vigoda was, and I told him it was The Godfather.
You told me to name one movie. I did.
Dude, I remember. I used to love him. He was in Look Who's Talking.
Yeah, he was. You're right. He was. Yeah, he was the grandpa. 30 years ago, he was playing grandfathers, and he kept.
Well, his joke, if you watch all those old like Dean Martin roasts, he was old then, and they used to make fun of him dying.
Exactly. And that was, what, the 70s?
He's always been old. Like, I don't think he was born and then went old.
Those Dean Martin roasts, a lot of those are on YouTube. Those things hold up, man.
I watch them all the time. I was just watching some last night, actually. Literally, just watched some last night.
Yeah, you don't know who half the people are, but they're just like drunk off their ass and calling each other racial slurs. That's never not funny.
Oh, no. Well, you know, we're talking about Don Rickles. Like, he's the king of that. And he gets away with that, today. Like, he's not politically correct. That's why I love him. He hasn't changed with time. He's not politically correct. And he gets away with it because people don't know that he's doing an act. He's joking. People know how much of a great guy he actually is.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Well, I love it. And, you know, he's got lots of black friends, so. Yeah. Well, he had. They're all dead.
Well, if you watch those, I don't know who the fuck Nippy is. I guess he was on a show, but he's always
Nipsey Russell.
Yeah, he's always on his ass. in those roasts. And he seems to love it. So,
well, that's why Don Rickles and you know, not just Rickles, but guys of his generation, that's why they got away, and women actually of that generation, that's why they got away with all the racism and sexism, because they had the theory that if you're going to dish it out, you got to take it back. And so they dished it out, but they were the first one to stand up and take it. So that's why it works. That's why it's funny and not offensive, because it's a give and take. Stand up and take.
Yes, Chris.
Yeah.
So the one good thing, I guess, if we're going to do a quick 2016 recap, the one thing good thing that came out for all of us is Twitch. I guess we all started Twitch. Good for better, for worse. What
you
is that noise?
Very loud.
Yeah, you're fucking up the entire show. Bad.
Well, I can hear myself yelling from the other room, so I was trying to message Michelle to turn down the volume.
Oh.
I was trying to be quiet about it, but...
Yeah, that was fucking super
loud. It didn't
fucking
work.
Anyway, yeah. Fucking... Show's ruined.
You're talking about Twitch. All right,
you're talking about Twitch. I'll start Twitch this year. We have a 33% success rate, which is pretty good. Chris is popular. Vinny and I are in the shitter.
I don't understand.
I lumped you in with me. Can I hope that's okay?
I don't know. I'm starting to bounce back a little bit.
Fuck both of you guys then. God damn it. Yeah.
But no, the one thing what gets me is funny because like the viewer, I mean the follow rate continues to grow. It's the viewer average.
Well, that's
viewer
what I care about.
Grow.
The view count.
No, that's what you should care about. Like,
yeah.
I don't know. We passed 800 this week. Passed 800 followers this week.
Yeah, come
for
on.
Me. That was kind of cool.
Nice. I got like 200 or 300.
You know what? 631.
Me and Banks are trying to branch out into different communities, and it's almost like hitting the restart button. So
yeah.
So that's what we're trying to do a little bit.
Yeah,
so.
And that's really what it is. It's just, you know, it's hard to actually. I've had as when I because I go into a lot of other streams and watch. I've actually had a lot of people, for what it's worth, compliment me on playing other stuff and trying to get into other communities and not just being an SMM streamer. Yeah. So it all amounts to zilch when I'm sitting here playing by myself.
If you told me, no, I'm sorry. I'm saying if you told me I could be somewhat successful and a partner and all that stuff, but have to just play Mario Maker endlessly. I don't want to do it. Like I don't, that's not what I started Twitch to do.
Right. It's not worth it.
So you could take your fucking 50 plus viewers or your thousands of followers. If I'm going to be, it will be like another job. Like if I'm not going to be happy doing this,
what's the
point?
Exactly.
Well, and I want more than five people watching me play something else, but
yeah, the reality is with SMM, you're not going to be big enough to quit your job. You're not going to bring in enough revenue from it.
No.
Partnered or not, so I do want to qualify my previous statement. Lady Stacy is always there watching, and Gorilloid is usually there too. So
I'm not
ever by myself.
I take ownership.
When I'm not on, they're watching you. Yeah,
I take ownership of Lady Stacy.
Right.
I discovered
as soon as Chris goes on, they all leave.
Yeah,
she'll deny if I discovered Stacy and I brought her to you guys.
You discovered Stacy. We all. Yeah.
She found me during Mario Kart one time, and she played with us and. I brought her to our community.
That's true, actually, because I'm sure that I met Stacy through your group. So,
yeah, and me too. So,
well, we do a show together. We share a lot of guys, people, for better or worse. We're a team.
Yeah,
we just pass them around.
We're not a stream team, but we're a team. How dare you
speak?
Bang and how dare you talk about Stacy like that? She's a very classy woman. She's married.
I was talking about everybody.
She's just taking
one viewer at a time.
She told me not to tell you, but
yeah,
she's expecting.
Yeah.
She doesn't want that.
What?
She's expecting. She didn't want that. Well, you know, she didn't tell her parents
yet. Our
eight
viewers won't tell anybody. Don't worry.
But anyway, we discovered
eight viewers. Holy shit, we're coming up in the world.
Well, it includes three of us. So.
Well. No. Anyway, all three of us kind of discovered Twitch this year. It was cool. We made new friends, and we started the show. And Chris, how was your 2016 in a nutshell?
My 2016 in a nutshell. I mean, you know, my memory's so bad. I barely remember what I ate for dinner yesterday. But to be honest, like, it's been pretty darn good. Like, Let's see. What was I doing?
I didn't hate you before. I really hate you now.
Yeah, I know, right? I don't even remember what I did before Twitch. I like... Oh, I played Magic the Gathering. That's right. So most of my nights were spent in a hot comic book store getting sweaty with other fat dudes, playing cards. And it was a wonderful experience. Wonderful, wonderful. I spent so much money on that game, man. It was like... Because every 3 months, the cards rotate, so old cards can't use them, new cards come in. And I was spending, like, hundreds of dollars every goddamn month, and it's like, geez. But then, you know, I got into Twitch, and I was like, oh, fuck this card game. I'm not playing this anymore. And, man, Twitch just fucking took over my life. And I've loved it. So here I am. Wonderful year with Twitch. How was your year, Vinny?
Well, if you watch my channel, you know how my year has been. Not to be a down, I won't get that much into it, but I like to say my 2016 has been a roller coaster, but mostly a roller coaster that started on the top, just swooped right the fuck down, and just been little bumps. Not even fun, just like a kid's coaster the rest of the year. You know, it's almost been a year back in February. I quit a job that was pretty good money. I just was tired of the industry and I wanted out. And I thought I had something lined up and that fell through. And this whole year has just been about finding my way. You know, I was on my own. I was living in a different state. Now I had to move back. I had to move back home with my parents. Like, that's not embarrassing. But I'm just trying to find my groove. You know, I mean, just trying to find. I've quit more jobs this year than I ever had before, and you know, I started Twitch, and that's been a nice little shining light, kind of. You know, I'm starting to get into the philosophy that maybe Twitch is keeping me from really getting going because I'm so focused and so obsessed with this that maybe it's hurting my development to start my life, but
to start your life.
Well, to restart my life, I should say. You know what I mean? Like, my... A career. I need a fucking career, you know, at this point that I'm trying to find. And, yeah, that's 2016 has probably been the worst year of my life. My adult life. But with a couple things here and there. Yeah, not to be a downer, but, you know, we'll see what happens next year. What about you, Banks?
The first 6 months of 2016 were really, really good. And the second half of 2016 corrected me on any disillusions I had about being happy. We went into 2016 with a bunch of big plans and a bunch of big goals. And fucking reality slapped me anyway in the face on any ideas I had about, you know, I don't know, branching out, I guess. Or
what do you mean, though? What's so bad about the last half of this year? I mean, aside from Twitch.
Twitch is the least. Twitch is the least of it. We had a rough. Yeah, we had a really bad. Basically, from mid July forward, like, we just had a really bad succession of events. And the thing about it is that we. How do I explain this? You know, sometimes like little things happen to people, but because they make no planning and they have no preparation, it's a complete catastrophe, right? So for us, because I'm such a planner and I'm such a, like, I've always had my hands wrapped around everything in my life, financially, personally, whatever, you know. So when little things would happen to us, you know, little inconveniences, little setbacks, they were never that big of a deal. And then, you know, like Vinny, I quit my job because it was really paid really well, but I was tired of the place I worked. And I started the industry. I want to get out of it. And we had these plans that I was going to do something different. And we set out in 2016, we're going to do these different things. And then when that thing didn't pan out, then this other thing happened. And then this other thing happened. And then this other thing happened. And we had like these huge, what would be for other people, any one of them would have been catastrophic. We had like 10 of these events in the last 6 months. And it's just like, there's only so much that can go wrong before you just like, you can't even, Like, you can't, you just can't, you lose the ability to just look past it and stay positive, you know? You're just, you like, you start to get destroyed, you know, from the pressure, from the stress and all that. And I forgot what my point was, but 2016
sucks.
It's really cliche to say, oh, 2016 was awful and, you know, can't wait till it's going to be over. But I mean, like, 2016 was really, and it's a dichotomy because we came into 2016 with these huge goals and this incredible positivity, and we were going to do all this stuff. And it's like, just when we were about to make that move and fulfill all of these things we've been talking about for years, the world just said, you know, go fuck yourself. We're going to make sure you can't, you know what I mean?
No, but this is what you've been prepared for, brick wall.
Like,
what? Oh yeah, not working. Well, you remember, Chris? We had that conversation in a streamer's chat where they're like, "Oh, you're so lucky, you know, you can stay home and stream." Well, no. I worked my ass off for 15 years to be in a position where I didn't have to go to work every day for a little while. You know what I mean? But the plan wasn't for me to not work. The plan was for me to do other stuff. And so the plan was I was going to open a bar. This is what I've always wanted to do. I wanted to open a bar.
Yeah.
And we moved out to this kind of not rural, but more rural than where we grew up. Let's put it that way. And sort of expecting, because there's not a lot of stuff going on out here, that we could kind of get in on the ground floor a little bit. And we just found that, I found that it was, it's hard to explain it. It's hard to summarize, but there's just a weird attitude out here. So, I looked at a couple of places, and they had completely unrealistic expectations of for rent rates out here. They wanted way more than what these places were worth for rent. It's like, you can't possibly make a profit doing that, right? So I was like, okay, well, I guess I'm not leasing that place. And with this other place, I'm like, well, I don't know, it's a little bigger than I wanted. And then the place got leased out from under me, and I'm like, that's all right. It probably wasn't a good fit. And that place now is hemorrhaging money, so I don't feel too bad about it. But there's just not a lot of options. And in the meantime, we're running through that nest egg in living expenses. And I mean, all right, fuck it. Let's just talk about it. So we make it to July, and I'm still positive. Everything's great. I'd started streaming. Streaming was going great. I wasn't doing Mario Maker yet. I was just doing retro stuff. I was playing GameCube most of the time. And I was basically where you're at right about now. I was, you know, about 200, 300 followers. I was feeling great about it. I'm like, oh my God, you know, cause I'm not playing. As far as the games I'm playing, I'm down around 100 deep on the games list, you know?
Oh, wow.
So I was feeling pretty good about it. Yeah. I was playing like Luigi's Mansion and Star Fox Adventures and just all these old games that nobody's looking for. So these were people that knew me from other streams as a viewer who were coming to check it out. And then they were sticking around and being a part of the community.
That's exactly what happens to me, but go ahead.
Yeah. No, yeah. Well, and frankly, to a certain extent, when I started playing Super Mario Maker, I stopped seeing a lot of those people. A bunch of new people came in, but I stopped seeing those people. And then when I quit playing Mario Maker, I lost all those new people, and the old people are starting to come back slowly but surely. So we go on this road trip that we'd been planning. We were going to be gone 3 weeks. We're so excited. Like, who is in a position to go on a three-week vacation? There ain't many people that can do that, right?
That's crazy, yeah.
We're going on a three-week vacation, and I'm sorry. I don't want to bring the show down because it's supposed to be a comedy show, but this is what happened. It's really funny because, like, for the first week and a half, like, anything that could go wrong went wrong, but we were still so positive. We were just like, that's just part of the trip. That's part of the story. Like, oh my God, that's so stupid. I can't believe that happened. Blah, 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 blah. And then halfway through the trip.
I was freaking out the entire fucking time.
Huh?
Oh, wait, nothing. Never mind. I'm lost. You lost me. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Okay. I'm listening.
Okay.
Vinny was on your trip. You didn't know it?
Yeah, I was going to say. I didn't even know Vinny yet. So
I was responding to something else. I responded to something else. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
You're fine. We got into what should have been a fatality accident. Somebody should have been dead. We were in a Honda Fit. I'm going to tell the story from my perspective. We were doing, it's a 40-mile-an-hour highway. Okay.
Yeah. That's
never, 40 mile an hour. No. I was coming out of a turn lane. I was getting up to speed. I will go to my grave that I was at 30 The police report said I was doing 5 to 10. I don't know how they could possibly know that. The $80,000 Ford Raptor was doing 90. I don't care what anybody says. They were doing 90 because everybody on that highway does 90. They're coming off the resort area. They're getting out of town. They're going wherever. They do fucking 90 miles an hour down that road all day, all night. Everybody does it. And he didn't even try to stop. He never hit his brakes. And we got rear-ended. So we're in a Honda Fit, and he hits me with a Ford Raptor, which is an F-150 fully decked out.
Oh, geez.
It's a huge fucking truck, and we're in a tiny little hatchback. Okay? Somebody should be dead from my car. And the general consensus, I don't care what, I know people say, oh, it's not your fault. It wasn't your fault. Nah, the general consensus is it was my fucking fault. Okay? So I go into severe PTSD. I can't drive. I can't talk to people because I feel like nobody was hurt, but I still feel like shit because, you know, somebody could have been killed. It's a miracle nobody was hurt, it's a miracle nobody was killed, let alone nobody was hurt. You know, but I, you know, everyone's like, oh, you need to go to the hospital, you need to go to the hospital, and kind of giving me side eye, you know, and I'm like, you know, what the fuck you want me to do? So that was that. We try to crack on with our road trip. I've got to rent cars now to get home. I almost just bought a car. I almost just said, fuck it, let's buy a car. But I was, you know, I decided to wait till we got home. I got to rent cars to get us home. We've got a leg of our trip in Las Vegas. So I had to rent a car to get us to Las Vegas and then another car to get us home because it was cheaper and it didn't make any sense, but that's what it worked out. We get back. We find out that my wife is pregnant, completely unplanned. Nobody knows because we haven't talked about it. And then a couple months later, we lose the baby. And everything that goes along with being pregnant and then everything that goes along with losing the baby. She goes back to work, obviously. I mean, she was working the whole time, but she's a teacher. So school year starts up. She took this new job specifically, explicitly stating she didn't want to be in a behavior program. And they swore fucking up and down that it wasn't, and it sure as shit is. They just don't call it that because they don't want to be one of those schools. They just slap a different fucking name on it. So she comes home from work every day with like scratches, and you know, she's getting punched and kicked by a bunch of fucking elementary school kids.
What is a behavioral program?
Just you know, the bad kids. I mean, it's where they stick the bad kids.
Okay.
You know? And I'm sitting on my ass fucking playing video games all day. So I feel like a piece of shit. You know, how was your day? Well, my day was all right. I played, you know, Mario Brothers all day long. Oh, well, I got beat up for eight hours.
You're bitching that no one's watching you. And she's
getting I'm bitching because nobody's fucking watching. My wife's, you know, getting, you know, having to deal with this shit. You know, so there you go. There was the latter half of my 2016.
I drink
during the show.
That sucks, man. Like, I was in the car accident thing. And I know exactly what you're talking about, PTSD.
Yeah.
You know, obviously it's not the same as your situation, but I was actually the one who caused a car accident.
Mm.
And I caused
it. According to everybody, so am I.
Yeah, well. Yeah. I just wasn't looking, and I was going way too fast, and I was going up a hill on a fucking freeway, and on the other side of the hill was this truck that I hit, and it ended up being a 4-car accident, right?
Yeah.
And you know, it's a 5-lane highway. We blocked off all the lanes except for one. So you know, when you're ever in one of those situations, you're going down the freeway, it's like, oh, what fucking idiot did this? And you know, that was me. And the guy who I hit ended up losing peripheral vision in his eyes. He got really fucked up his knee. That's because he was in one of those piece of shit, like not like a Ranger truck, but the same kind of,
yeah, like an S10 or something.
Yeah, something like that. But it's like old, didn't have a bumper and all that. He wasn't wearing a seatbelt either. And his truck flipped. And you know, if I wasn't wearing a seatbelt, I would have died, because I was in this 1970s fucking big ass car.
That sounds about,
you know,
right
with you. The fucking, you know, like a 6-foot between, you know, where you're driving and the front of the car. And man, I could not drive for like at least a month after that. I just it was just ridiculous. So I know what you're talking about with that, you know, that going on. Sounds like it's a lot worse with the, you know, with you.
Nobody flipped a car, so I don't know, but.
Well, but 90 versus 30 is, you know.
Yeah.
That's why I hate people who drive pickup trucks. I hate pickup trucks. I absolutely just hate pickup trucks. Most people drive pickup trucks, if it's not work-related, are just fucking assholes. They never park right. They always think they own the fucking road.
Yeah, the full size, the big trucks. Yeah, you're right.
Unless they fucking need it for work. If I ever become dictator of the United States, I'm banning fucking.
You're banning trucks.
Unless it's for like business purposes. Yeah, or Bangs. I don't know if you probably don't want to get into it, but
no, go for it. What's up?
It's very personal. Just cut me off, you know, just okay. So I don't want to talk about it. But I'm sorry to hear about, you know, half the shit you went through. I kind of knew some of it, but now, how do I phrase it? Would you, if you guys decide you want to sit down and have children, is there future complications, or was it just an unfortunate, terrible event?
No, it was just one of those things. There was, as far as we know, I mean, the reality is, because we're experts on this now, the reality is that something like 80% of pregnancies end in miscarriage. Yeah. People just don't even know they're pregnant. Like, that's how quick it is. So a miscarriage is so common as that they don't even look any further. If you have 2, 3, or 4 miscarriages, then they start digging deeper into what may cause it. But the first one is just so common that it's not even, they just go, yeah, that happens sometimes.
How'd you guys find out?
There was some sort of chromosomal abnormality and your body said, this is not a viable pregnancy, and said, we're done.
That's where I work.
I
work at a genetics laboratory where they send the products of conception. Oh. We grow up the cells and we say, oh, this one had an extra 21 chromosome. This one had, you know, double the
Chris
amount
has never
of
told
chromosome.
Us exactly what he does.
Yeah. I work in a cytogenetics laboratory.
So if I ever need help knocking up a woman, I can come to you?
No. But if she ever miscarries and it goes inside a, you know, you get like a DNC or something like that, and you send what is left to us, we do our thing and we say, oh, the baby had, you know, fucked up chromosomes or whatever. And we, you know, I also do shit where like people send us bone marrow to find out what kind of cancer they have. Hmm. Or like, let's say Bangs, if you and Bangs Michelle got your blood drawn and you sent it to us saying, oh, you know, infertility or whatever, we would say, oh, like you have a balanced translocation, which, you know, this is probably not interesting to anybody, but you have 23 chromosomes, right?
Right.
And you have 2 each of each one of them. And so if like the top of one decides to go to the bottom of another and they switch like that, it's called a translocation. And when you pass on that chromosome, you're fine because you have all the same genetic material. But when you pass on that chromosome, the child inherits that chromosome and they end up having too much of one type of genetic material and not enough of another. So,
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
I'm following.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So, if it becomes an issue, it could be one of you have, you know, this weird mutation that doesn't affect you, but it affects your children.
Right. Huh.
Yeah.
if Chris wasn't married, I didn't know like his wife, I could see him definitely being like the weirdo that's like smearing miscarriage and afterbirth all over him while he masturbates. Just naked in the lab.
Vinny, here's the thing though. I see these things. I see a six week old fetus in a cup that gets sent to me. So
how
that's
big
not
is that?
Really, it's fucking small, dude. It's like a quarter.
What I thought.
Yes, dying, it's a raspberry according to the app we have.
Would you eat the afterbirth? Like, no, people actually do. I mean, it's like if you had,
I know.
Like,
oh, afterbirth. Sorry, you're talking about the placenta.
Yeah, I'm talking about afterbirth. Yeah. Oh, yeah, placenta and all that shit. I'm not talking about.
Vinny's on another page. He's like 9 months ahead of us.
Dude, I'm all over the place. All right, so if I'm being honest, like before, all day I've been dealing with this fucking mind crippling headache where I can't even. Think. I've been staring into at a fucking wall all day, and I had to really come together for the show tonight. So I'm out there. Like, I don't even know what the fuck I'm thinking about right now.
Are you on drugs, Vinny?
No, but it feels like I'm loopy.
He wishes he was.
I might drown a bottle of NyQuil after this.
Why? I thought you were on those pills. You not taking them today?
What pills? The fuck are you accusing me of?
Never mind.
My Xanax? I haven't had my Xanax. No, that was months ago when I was popping those like 10 at a time.
Oh, yeah.
I don't do that anymore.
I'm not up on the.
He doesn't do it anymore.
I didn't run out. I'm just running low, and I don't have insurance to get more. So I gotta, in case I need them.
Okay.
I love a good Xanax. When I get super depressed, this has been 2016 has been the year of depression for me. Like I've always suffered from depression, but this has been the year where like crippling depression, where my mind has gone to some dark fucking places this year that I never thought my mind would go to. And wow, this show is real fucking down in the last one of the year.
Well,
episode 10.
2016.
Yeah, 2016.
I thought we agreed we were skipping 2016.
Can we go back to rating women? Can we go back talk about ass and pussy and vagina?
Ass and pussy.
That's where the show really flourishes.
Yeah.
My friend Ray is in the chat right now. I don't know if he's still in there, but talk about a man who gets fucking pussy. He's half black, half Puerto Rican, but he looks white. I don't know. I don't understand it. But he gets some top of the line poo nanny.
Is he a Rico Suave?
He actually worked at the job. I met him in Pennsylvania at the job I quit, which I probably should have never quit. The one I was talking about earlier in the year, and he's a good guy. He's a real good guy.
Well,
good. Very sensitive. We used to go out for drink, some beers and wings and stuff, and he would just. He had his pick of the waitress that he could just bring home to fuck.
He says, "I am amazing."
Yes, I'm envious of him. I love being white. I don't think I'd want to be any other race, but if I can be Ray, I think I'd take that. Okay. Thank you.
Sorry, I was lost in thought for a second.
So, yeah. Vinny, you were talking about your year and you're talking about careers and stuff like that. What career, if you could choose, what career would you actually want to be in? Now that we're doing the up stuff, I'm going to put my sunglasses back on.
I want to own.
I noticed you took your glasses off. I appreciate the respect.
Yeah.
I want to own a brothel. I want to be like, I want to stable a hose. And I'd hire a bottom bitch to run the place. Maybe Stacy.
Oh,
Lady Stacy. Well, there's nothing wrong with that. That's just the title, man. The bottom bitch is the person who runs the stable for me when I'm not around. They don't do any whoring. They keep the bitches in line.
Now, would you dip into the product?
Of course.
That's why
I'd be like, what's his name? The guy who runs the bunny ranch, Dennis. He has to touch. Yeah. He has to test all the girls before. No.
Casting
couch. Yeah, he has to. It's required.
It's my job,
Listen, this is just regulation. You understand?
Honestly,
you sticking my dick in your pussy. It's all business. It's fine.
Or somewhere else.
Honestly, if I had to pick a profession that I could do, that's the problem why I'm having trouble finding. That's why I've quit so many jobs this year. Is I can't find a passion. I don't know what I'm passionate in. I don't know what I want to do. I feel so lost in that retrospect. I love Twitch and streaming. If you told me tomorrow I could be a big time streamer, with, you know, hundreds of thousands of followers, I'd take that. For years I worked in I did the surveillance thing, casino, but it's a lot of camera work. The one thing I do enjoy about that job, not so much the job, it's the camera, the man behind the camera. That intrigues me. I kind of like that whole, like, you know, like you watch, shows and there's like
it's
whole
voyeurism.
Well, yeah, but I meant I'm more like a technical standpoint with the whole cameras and all that stuff, where I wouldn't mind getting into like the film industry, not so much anything in front of the camera, but you know, the whole what is that called? The you know, the guy, the production firm area.
Yeah, producers, cameramen.
Yeah, shit like that.
Cinematography.
Yeah.
Kate calls me a savage. Why would she call me a savage?
And we can't.
She's someone else I used to work with. She's a nice woman. She has a kid and all that stuff. But we used to butt head once in a while. But it was only because we're two different people. But I hold nothing against her. I hope she. You know, whatever. We're talking personal, Chris. This is a big time production. This turns into a podcast and stay forever. We have a website. God damn it.
Wait, what?
Vinny's very proud of the website part of things.
What are you criticizing me for? I don't understand.
Not you. Oh, Ray. I meant Ray. My bad, Chris.
He's so used to cussing you
I'm
out.
Like, what I'm the so, fuck? I know. I'm so used to yelling at you.
I was like, what did Chris do?
So used to yelling at you.
I thought you were going to say something about how I'm not sharing anything. I'm talking about Magic the Gathering fucking Twitch, and you guys are talking about...
We've had just downer years. You're a simpleton, and you've had nice stuff happen to you.
Well, I will say that me and my wife are trying to get pregnant.
Are you really? I thought you guys never wanted kids.
No, I'm fine either way. I'm fine either way. Well, here's my problem. Like, you know, Vinny, you're talking about depression. I totally relate. It runs in my family. And you don't know
what depression is.
Fuck you, man.
Let him go.
I have four bottles in front of me of shit I have to take every day so I don't kill myself.
What do you take? Like, oh, no, we talked about this before, I think.
I just have one bottle.
Well, you shouldn't have that bottle.
It doesn't help, but I feel better.
Why are we all psychopaths? Maybe that's why we're drawn to each other.
I don't know. I think probably. It fucking runs in my family, so... I don't. You know what? Do I have to take the glasses off? Are we getting serious?
No. I actually want to hear what you had to say, actually.
So... I forgot where I was going. I was saying that, you know,
you guys are trying to get pregnant.
We're trying to get pregnant. So what happens when you pass on your genetic material and your genetic material is basically fucked? You're basically bringing a child into this world who is going to have all sorts of problems. It's going to be miserable. And you know, it's like, oh, my 6-year old wants to kill himself. It's like, I don't know about that, man. I don't know if I want to.
Yeah,
it's really difficult because I can go either way. Like, I would love to be a father. I would love to pass on my knowledge. The fact that, you know, my parents were divorced ever since I was like 9 or 10. I didn't see my dad very much. My mom is a working mom, and I had no parenting in my life and no role models in my life. So it did not help. You know, I sat in a room, played with Legos, and then I ended up playing video games. You know, entertaining myself. Fuck, I was 16 years old and I had my girlfriend living with me in the house. My mother only stopped by to drop off groceries, and she would go sleep at her boyfriend's house. So you could imagine how fucking left alone and why am I saying all this shit? Oh my god, this is like venting show.
That's all right.
It's venting show. I thought you were gonna go the route is the only time your mom would bother you is when you guys were fucking too loud. She'd be banging on the door and be like, "Chris,
I knew where it was going." I'm like,
"Chris, keep it down in there." Me and my boyfriend are fucking.
Yeah, me and 16 and 17, and I was having sex every day for like a year. It's like,
oh, that was me too. 15 to 16.
Yeah. Like, I mean, yeah. No, that was totally me too. Totally.
Oh, dude.
No, she never, like, when we first started dating, she would come in and like she caught us messing around and she got all pissed off. But eventually she actually signed the papers that like my girlfriend's dad and my mom went to the fucking bank and signed those papers and got them notarized where she basically adopted her. Like the guardianship.
Yeah, guardianship, yeah.
Yeah. And it was so fucking weird.
Like, it is weird.
She was the girl I lost my virginity to, and half day of school. Love those.
Wait, what?
Half day
you
of
lost
school.
Your virginity and got half day of school? Is that
No. It was the other way around. I got half day of school, so I lost my virginity because my mom was at work.
Okay.
And we went home and banged and... anyway,
you just keep talking, Chris. I'm just
gonna fucking keep talking. I just keep hating you more.
Happy school depression. All right. Yeah, no. Because Chris, I have all the bad shit you have. I don't have any of the good shit that went along with it.
I don't hate anybody
at 16, 17 years old.
I lost my virginity on like the birthday of like my 15th birthday party. It was weird.
Oh, yeah. Ona's watching.
Yeah,
I just saw that. That's why we can adopt.
I don't want to have kids because I don't want to like you with the genes, like my depression and mental state, but just the look. I don't want to pass this.
Look, how old are you, Vinny? You're in your 20s, right?
Yeah, my late 20s.
Okay, you're late 20s. I mean, okay, never mind.
Well, good. It's riveting.
Thank you. I thought you were older.
What were you gonna say?
I was just, you know, you're, I don't know. I was just gonna say, well, who cares? You know, everyone looks ugly when they get old, but you're not old. I'm sorry. That's why aren't you guys? Why aren't you guys laughing? This is supposed to be funny.
Fuck you, Chris.
Okay. It's my beard. Funny when we make those jokes, Chris. When you make those jokes, it's offensive.
Yeah.
It's well, it's, I'm you think, fucking old, guys.
Chris doesn't want to. Chris doesn't want kids. I have a feeling like he's like coming, but he's like squeezing the shit out of the base of his dick.
Kids. He said he does.
I do.
But no, but to prolong it, he's probably squeezing the shit out of it, like the end of his dick when he's coming, and then so that way he doesn't come inside of her, and then pinching he just. It off. Yeah, he pinches it off and pulls down and rushes to the bathroom.
Pinches
just...
it off. Yeah, I don't want to have a fucking orgasm. I mean, come on. I don't want to come inside a girl. I mean, what's wrong with you? Who would want to do that?
Chris keeps telling Ona that she can get... Never mind.
Are you watching this on the large TV? I hope not. With the fucking family around.
Hi, Mom and Stepdad.
So.
There's a 52-inch TV.
This
in the
is
other
also
room.
Why, by the way, back to the start. Well, I think it was pre-show that we talked about it. This is why nobody I know in real life watches the show. Because it's conversation.
I advertise this on my Facebook.
They're like, we don't want to hear about your bullshit. Fuck you.
I hope no one actually responded to my Facebook.
Never mind.
I'm sending
you. I keep wanting to go places that are inappropriate.
Just go places. It's a fucking talk
at
show.
At this point, you might as well go there because I had to run an errand today and I was trying to brainstorm like what stories I was, because this fucking stupid topic was my idea. Don't ever listen to me ever again on show topics, because every topic I've come up with has been a shit show. And I'm like, fuck, I just realized that we got show in like 4 hours and I don't have anything to talk about. So I was like brainstorming. I was trying to think of bar stories and all, you know, things I could talk about New Year's Eve. And we're talking about 2017. And then I was like, I know we're going to talk about 2016. And I just started like replaying in my head. And when I drive, I talk to myself. I will relive conversations. I will have hypothetical conversations. I will just discuss whatever interests me in the moment. I cannot drive without talking to myself.
You talk
to myself. God bless cell phones. Everyone thinks I'm on the phone. Everyone just assumes I'm on the phone.
Do you hold a phone up to you? You're like,
no, because I got Bluetooth. But I have myself. Tara catches me because when we're in the car together, I'll be like in my head. It'll be all in my head, but she'll catch my lips just like barely fluttering and she'll go, what are you thinking about? And I won't tell her because what I'm thinking about is either really stupid, just spilled my drink, really stupid or really dark. And I'm just like, not happening. Anyway, I'm thinking about the shit about 2016 and I got myself so worried. And I ended up telling the story anyway, but I got myself so worked up into a frenzy over how shitty 2016 was. I almost didn't do the show.
What?
Yeah. I was like, nope, not doing it. Not reliving it. What is it? Kristopher?
Well, here we go. Where are we living in now?
What?
Wait, what's that? What? No, have you ever thought about, you know what would be the best, or probably not the best, is if you like recorded yourself talking, this doing this whole talking thing? Is it just too real? Is it too real to do that?
I mean, to what end? Just recorded myself like what?
Well, you're talking to yourself in the car, so right. Like, what if you just hit the record? But like, you have your headphones in right now. I'm sure you could use those headphones with the phone where you're talking into it. Just hit the record button.
And do what with it?
I don't know. Well, like, well, here's the thing. Like, I've done that before. Like, I was in a real depressed state, and I used to write like a lot of poetry when I was a kid. Like, I would just sit.
Yeah, I could see
right,
that.
Right. And I would, well, once I got into music, I started doing recording. Like, you could buy this little 4-track tape machine and you could layer stuff and, you know, everything has its own volume. Mm-hmm. And I would record myself talking and doing stuff like that. So it's one of those things that I'm interested in. So that's kind of why I bring it up. But mm-hmm. like, once I was in this huge depressed state and I was laying on a couch and I couldn't even feel like I could move. And I recorded myself, talking the whole thing out and mm-hmm. listening to it later was like, wow, it was like mind blowing.
Oh,
I don't know if I still have that somewhere, yeah, but it's just
I get what you're saying.
Yeah,
I would never listen back to it.
No, you're not. Well, I'm kind of a narcissist, so I like to.
I've never listened back to this show. I've never watched any of the show.
Really?
I skimmed through it. I like the podcast.
I think the first episode. I think the Switch episode. I checked the podcast to make sure that I did it right.
Yeah.
But once I figured that out, I was like, oh, we're good to go. I've never looked at. I don't go back and watch any of my own shit, like my streaming stuff. Sometimes someone will post like they've clipped something, and I'll go back and watch. I'll watch that because it's 30 seconds and it's, you know, sort of interactive. Like, oh hey, here's this thing I posted, and I'll watch it and I'll laugh with them. But I. You know, it's funny. When I was a teenager and in my early 20s, I thought, going back actually to Vinny's point, I thought I was going to be a filmmaker. That was my passion. That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to write and direct and do all that stuff. And I made some, what were probably very good decisions, but they completely shackled me from being able to just say, fuck it, and like moving to LA and trying to get into Hollywood, right?
Yeah.
The fuck was I gonna say?
That's why you just gotta stop drinking before the show, goddammit.
You're talking about following your dreams and how you didn't.
Yeah, I don't remember.
Follow your dreams,
but don't.
Never mind. It's gone.
Okay.
Sorry. I had to. You know what? We joke because I drink during the show. I had to drink to get up for this show. Which is a little scary, but I had to drink.
Why is that? The show.
Because of the shit we fucking talked about. Because I had to talk myself down to think and then get to like other content for the show, like other stuff to talk about. I have a whole freaking list of shit to talk about that's much lighter and much more entertaining. But we went, you know, where we always go. We went, in a good way, we always go to reality. The thing I love about Twitch, the way the three of us do it, not necessarily the way everybody else does it, is that it always goes to reality. It is authentic. It is what it is. It's unpolished. It's unabashed. It's real time. It's exactly what it is. There's no, like, I forget the name of it, but there's this, like, they have a name for it. It's a condition. It's a social media condition because everybody posts, like, this filtered version of their life onto Facebook and Instagram.
Right.
And so when you're looking at your friends, all of your friends' lives are perfect and they're doing all these crazy, amazing things. And it's so great. And you're so jealous because you're only posting the good shit too, but you're also living all the other shit. Like even if it's not bad, just the mundane stuff, just getting up Monday morning, going to work, coming home, doing that Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and then Friday night's awesome. Saturday's awesome. You know, whatever the case may be. The thing I love about this medium is that it doesn't have that veneer. You know, I say the word 1,000 times, it's about authenticity.
So that's
I like that we did it, but it took me, I had to get a little buzz to get there.
When I started my channel on Twitch, that's what I really wanted my channel, stream, show, whatever you want to call it, be about, which is realness. Like I was not going to create a character or put on, like, not everyone finds me funny, but on a natural thing, I think I have a good sense of humor. So I wanted my channel to be a little bit more on the funny side. But if I'm feeling sad or depressed, I wasn't going to hide that either. Like now, my depression has hurt me, my stream, because not everyone likes watching a depressed guy. Or sometimes it stopped me from even being able to stream altogether. But I wasn't going to be fake. I was going to be honest with my depression. I'm honest with my stories. Hell, I get honest with my emotions. The stream before Christmas, the guys made me fucking like cry on my channel. I fucking cried a little bit based on what was going on that particular channel. And that's the first time I did that. And I felt like a big pussy, but I was real.
You know, historically, it used to be men that cried were considered exceptionally strong because it was so, you know, to show vulnerability was a sign of strength. And somewhere along the line, we culturally did away with that. But even recent history, I'm talking about like in the early turn of the century.
Well, I wasn't bawling my fucking eyes out, but
no, I know. I wasn't there for that, but I heard about it. So I know what happened. So to Chris, Chris is confused. So Vinny, yeah. Vinny's
well,
we don't
need to talk
we're going
to
have a shitty Christmas.
We don't need it. I don't want to.
Okay.
That was a, you know, I felt I wasn't. What happened was I wasn't trying to get that response. I was just telling a story and just being me. And the response my stream showed me was amazing and generous and unbelievable. But I don't want. I still don't want. Okay. I can't get over the feeling that like I don't want that to. I don't know. I don't know how to say. I didn't want. I don't want people to think, oh, he did that on purpose or he was trying to get that reaction or. I was just generally being me. Like, I always am. I just tell stories and I tell, say what's going on in my life. And that's all I did.
And well, what's wrong with just being you? I mean, it seems like you're not even, it seems like you're a little embarrassed.
No, I'm talking about that one.
He's embarrassed by the reaction he got.
Yeah.
They were very generous.
People can relate. Oh, okay. I see what you're talking about. What happened? Okay. But you know what? When people give, it's not like they give completely selflessly. People give because it makes them feel happy.
Yeah, it feels good. Yeah, absolutely.
It feels great to give. And it's like, this person is kind of down on their luck. You know what? It's going to make me feel really good to
help them out.
You know, throw something. Yeah, to help them out.
Yeah.
It's like, Bangs, you had that with your refrigerator situation.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. And it's, you know, it creates a lot of happiness because, like, when people have donated to me on my stream, you know, I'll dance, I'll do, you know, it makes me extremely happy. And I think that makes them happy to see me happy.
No, yeah, so, I think that's everyone gets a joy. Yeah. Like, everyone would just be anonymous, whatever, if they want that feeling from it. Like, I've given to charity or donated because I want to feel better about myself.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I think it's natural.
I mean, it feels good to help people regardless of the what help you're offering. So, you know, that's why. I mean, you can say you help because they need it, but the reality is it's part of our hardwiring. It's part of who we are as animals that it feels good to help somebody.
Sure.
Yeah.
You know, it creates a positive feedback loop in the brain.
Yeah. I love giving.
Yeah.
So. You know, and you're, I don't know. Let's talk. You're talking about that Facebook thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
About how everyone seems to kind of, it's almost like, it's like it's fake book. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
100%.
Like, yeah. Yeah. And it's weird that it's turned into that. And then there's that dichotomy with us that we're being very real, mm-hmm. you know, Vinny was real and on his stream and he got, you know, a response to it. And, Bangs, you were talking about how you really enjoy the show because it's real. And it's like, it's weird that Facebook has evolved into that. Cause I feel that. I feel it's like,
I got off really Facebook.
Fake. Yeah. Yeah. I'm not into it anymore.
I was big on Facebook. I not deleted my account because, you know, you never know what you need, but I just did that thing where you just deactivate it. And yeah. I was off it for 6 months. I did not miss it. I recently reactivated it because I needed the message. You can't use Facebook Messenger without being activated. I need to get in touch with someone who I didn't have their number. And I still have it activated because I might need the messenger still, but I don't check it because you know why? It just leads to higher depression because, like Banks were saying, or just they did the study. People post basically all the good shit. Not a lot of people like airing out their bad shit. So all you're doing is you're reading a wall of everyone's life who seems like it's better than yours, and it leads to higher depression levels.
Tara and I were just watching a video this morning, and he had some good points, but he was, you know, it's like anything else. Everyone's like polarized one direction in order to make their point. But one of the statements he made that I've heard elsewhere is that there's like a significantly higher level of depression in people who use Facebook more often or however that
oh my
works.
God, I saw that video. I was watching that video with Ona
Simon Surak or something.
Did he open it up with Simon Says?
No, I didn't agree with all of his points because he just was you know, the thing is, he's a 43 or something year old man talking about millennials. Quote unquote. Yeah. And it's like, well, you're 43. Well, not only that, but he said the millennials started like 84. It starts at 79. So he like pushed 5 years out. And I kind of understand why he did, because I'm technically a millennial. Vinny's a millennial. I don't think either of us feel like millennials. Because, like, we remember a time before the internet and before cell phones, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So we don't feel like millennials, but we fall under that gauge. But, yeah, he was pretty
blanket statements.
Very blanket statements, and it's like, well, it's, you know, it's not that simple. It's nuanced, but yeah, one of the things he talked about, and again, I heard elsewhere, is that Facebook use, well, it's causality or causation. I'm not saying one or the other, but use of Facebook is somehow related to levels of depression. I'm going through my Facebook right now trying to find the last time I posted, and I can't find it because it picks up all my tweets. I use Twitter religiously. I love Twitter, but they're all, the tweets don't show up on Facebook. It just copies them and then locks them down. I can't even find my last Facebook. I look at Facebook every day, but I have like everybody hidden. It's a couple of corporate accounts, you know, like, you know, the businesses that I'm looking for deals and sales, you know, they post them on their Facebook. It's a couple of those, a couple of entertainment sites, and then like two friends, and everybody else I have hidden, and I don't post anything. I cannot find, I'm back into December and I can't find a post, like early December.
Oh, wow. See, like, you know, I'll like more than just write things. I will, you know, repost the share things, or I'll hit like on some things, and you know how you could see what other people liked.
Yeah.
And, you know, I mean, I occasionally post Christmas stuff. Lately I've just been posting shit about Twitch because, you know, Twitch has been, you know, basically my life in the last 3 months. And I don't know, I'm looking through my Facebook right now. And
Kool-Aid Man is telling me that Millennial starts at 84. So did they reassign this?
Facebook, I used to do a thing.
The stream again with my keyboard.
When I used to be really into Facebook, I used to just do like, I used to do this whole what pisses me off type thing. Every day I'd post something new that pissed me off. People like that. And I always the guy that I would just post stupid shit, like just stupid sayings or stupid, my thoughts of the day. You know how my mind works. So sometimes I get off some whacked. I just put it on Facebook. And when I was like in a really good place, we would have fun. We'd always tag each other in stupid ass things. And I still try to do it. But like when you're, I don't go on it anymore because like as I'm depressed as it is, it just brings me to an even darker place that I don't want to be at. But so I did away with Facebook.
Yeah,
it's probably for the best.
I say work. If I didn't need it for work, although I haven't done any work for them in 3 months, I'd get rid of mine too. So the range for millennials is as early as 76, depending on. So there's different, you know, research houses that give different dates. As early as 76, the latest I see is 82. The U.S. Census Bureau says 82 to 2000. So that's as official as you get.
My wife is a millennial and I am not.
Yeah, you're what's called a cradle robber.
Oh, come on. She's only 6 years younger than me.
Are you? Yeah, you'd be a Gen Xer, right, Chris?
Yeah. I'm a Gen Xer. I was full on Nirvana and Pearl Jam. And
that's the funny thing about that Simon guy with his video. I made that comment this morning when we were watching it because he was going on and on about millennials. And I'm like, you're a fucking Gen Xer. Your entire generation was about getting high and listening to music that we pretend is good, but actually most of it is shit.
Aww. And
it is. Listen, I'm from Seattle. Nirvana is way overrated.
Overrated, yes, but I loved them as a band. But then I loved a lot of their like B-sides and stuff that wasn't, you know, I loved Smells Like Teen Spirit, but it's like, you know, I still love like their first album, which was completely different than the fucking Nevermind album.
I like Dave Grohl more than
I like Dave Grohl too. I think the Foo Fighters are a better band than Nirvana, and they're so more too. They're more jokey, but I think their music's better.
Yeah, I mean, you know. Whatever. It's just
they're definitely both products of their times. You know, early 90s to late 90s were night and day. But
well, you know, the thing about growing up with Nirvana, because Nirvana came out in the mainstream in 91.
Sounds about right.
That means I like late 91, early 92. So in 91, I was 14 years old.
Is this a picture of you in a cover band?
Yeah. No. Not me in the cover
band. Oh, no. As a teenager.
As a teenager. Isn't that... We have to post that somehow.
I was going to say you shouldn't have done it because I'm saving it.
Where is this
picture? Yeah, you save it.
Oh, I'm posting it to Discord. Give me 2 seconds. Facebook.
It's from Facebook.
Oh, I won't
call it Facebook. I wanted him to see it. This
Chris
is,
smells know, like teen spirit. That's the name of the photo.
Oh, okay. Yeah, this is really bad radio, but...
Nope, it's going to be... Listen, no, it's great radio, and here's why. Because you need to join the Discord,
You need to join Vinny's Discord, my Discord, and Chris's Discord.
Where did you post it?
I'm posting it right now. I'm working on it. Jesus Christ.
While we were on the show Facebook, Michael Bang's friend requested me on Facebook.
You, congratulations. You're going to be like the third person that I actually look at their post.
Vinny, stop. Get your mouse away from my head.
Where the fuck
Chris
is...
in a Nirvana, what are you talking about? Cover band.
Oh, shit. That's my mouse is coming through.
Poking me in the eye with your mouse.
My bad. I didn't.
Why would your mouse come through? You're doing because you're doing monitor capture.
Yeah, and I never thought I'd put my fucking thing on that screen. Oh, yeah, so is. I never.
Oh, okay, we're not being
I never did non-capture.
Chris is like, what's his name from CSI Miami? Glass sunglasses on. It's jokey time. Serious time. Glasses off. Yeah, I can't see. Hold on.
Where's this picture?
It's on the Discord. I posted it in your general chat. My point is that you need to follow all three of us on Twitch because we don't just do the talk show. We also do stream.
General chat?
Your fucking general chat.
I got to scroll.
The fucking program.
Oh, my Lord, baby Jesus. This is on your channel.
I told you.
That's Chris.
I don't feel good.
That's true.
What is this? What the fuck is this?
Where was this? Fucking picture.
Oh, you look like such a stoner. Well, you're a stoner. It makes sense.
Allegedly.
Don't rat me out, bro.
He's allegedly a recreational drug user.
No. I never do drugs.
He allegedly drops acid on him.
No. I take.
He allegedly smoked angel dust. Allegedly. Oh. People are saying, and that's all you have to, that's the litmus test now. People are saying that Chris is a meth head.
I believe it.
Wow.
People are saying.
My teeth look like it. My teeth are so fucked up.
I just
people. I see it.
The best people. The smartest people are saying that Chris is a drug addict.
Did you see the stream, Ben?
I see it. I'm looking right at it. I said I saw it.
Good. Look at it.
It's beautiful. So, before we run out of time for the day, does anyone want to tell, since it's right before New Year's and going to 2017, does anyone have
that's going to be my background next week.
Nice. Does anyone want to share some type of New Year's story? Anyone have any memorable New Year's?
Stop trying to bring this show up, sir.
Okay. Fuck me, right?
I hate New Year's. I've worked most of my New Year's.
Yeah.
Because I worked in bars most of my 20s. So I worked, I was 21. I went on to a New Year's party. The next 4 years, I was working that New Year's party. And then... and then I wasn't working for like a year as far as the bars go. I don't think we went anywhere. I don't remember going anywhere. And because you know what the reality is? I hate all amateur nights. Vinny can relate working in the casinos. When you work in the industry, you don't go out on party nights. We call them amateur nights. You don't go out New Year's, Cinco de Mayo, St. Patrick's Day.
Thanksgiving.
Day before Thanksgiving. You especially don't go out the day before Thanksgiving. Especially because it's amateur night. It's when like all the assholes go out because it's like it's they feel like they got a hall pass to act like complete douchebag losers and there's no consequences, you know?
Those are always the worst. Okay, I'm sorry.
No, I was going to say you got the young kids who are like basically doing what they always do, but times 10. But the worst part is the 40, 50, 60-year-olds or even older that are trying to like recapture their youth. And they do it about 5 times a year, and it's those drinking holidays. And it's awful. It's bad enough when you're getting paid to be there. There's no reason on God's green earth I would ever personally pay to be a part of that. Not interested.
No, those were always the worst nights. Those were the worst nights to work. As an adult, I probably worked more New Year's than I was
100%. I have.
Casinos were rough, but what's nice about what I did in the casinos, I was on the casino floor. So it was busy. Don't get me wrong. It was busy for us because there's a lot of coverage that needs to be done between fights and drunk people and all that good stuff. So the casino's not liable. But you don't have to deal one-on-one directly with drunks, which is nice. Yeah. When I worked at the hospital, I worked 2 New Year's Eves, and that was overnights. And I worked security, and that was a shit show. That was a shit show because I worked a lot in the psych ward. So I remember one right as the ball's dropping, they're counting down 10. we got like an emergency. I had to rush out of the psych ward. They were bringing this real psychopath drunk because we used to do drunks too, just fighting, spitting. And it was just all night. We used to get, it would be 4 a.m. and people would be coming in with alcohol poisoning. And, you know, security, you would think that we just stood there, but you don't. Like, you get your gloves on. You have to rush out.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Like if someone's like having an emergency outside and needs to rush in, you're fucking rushing out there and you're getting them on the stretcher. You're getting them in the wheelchair. If you need to and you're the first one there, you start CPR.
Yeah, first responder.
Like, yeah. I've started CPR before. Like, I've had someone die underneath me. Like, and when you start, you don't stop. I remember this one time.
I never saved anybody, but I definitely choked a couple guys out on New Year's Eve.
I have.
I was always a door guy.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I had to fuck some people up sometimes too. But I remember, like, one time these kids, it was like New Year's Eve, and they just dropped off. They literally came up to the emergency room,
dropped their buddy off and ran.
Yeah, the guy was unresponsive, blue, vomit everywhere, and you know, it's fucking a shit show. So that kind of like deters you from even wanting to go out, from even wanting to do anything.
Yeah,
I had two that I can distinctly remember. It was mostly with my friends, and one is I was delivering pizzas. This was before, this was after the hospital, actually. It was around the same time. I was the cool guy because I got out of work at like 11 and I brought like 10 pizzas, and I worked at like Domino's, and like my best friend was like the GM. So I just could do whatever I want. So we made like 10 pizzas and it was fun, you know, typical house party. It was like, I was like 21. There was food, kegs, drinking games, women, drugs. I remember these two guys that didn't even fucking know dropped acid. It was fucking wild.
Maybe they didn't until then.
But, my biggest one, or the one I fucking probably hate the most, was, we went to this club. I don't like clubs. And like, we were just talking, we literally just talked about all this shit. I fucking hate it, but I got dragged because my one friend who passed away actually, a couple of years ago, he was a party animal and the drugs got the better of him. But, you know, he forced us to go to this fucking, couldn't even tell you where it is now. I don't even know what the fuck the club is. We got a hotel and that was kind of, I got fucked up, man. I made my one friend do Molly, who's never done drugs. I didn't even do Molly, but I made him do it. I was strung out on a, it was fun, but it wasn't. Who wants to be in a club New Year's Eve? Like you just said, the fucking music blast and the people. I remember I was drinking a vodka and cranberry and like I was dancing with this girl and I spilt it all over myself. And I was so fucked up that I gave her money because I thought I ruined her dress.
What?
You
still got Chris's bullshit picture up, by the way.
I know.
Yeah,
why is Chris sitting there like that? And then I realized, because I've got Chris on Skype, for those of you that can't see, I got Chris on Skype, so I can see him. I'm like, why is he sitting there like that? He never sits like that. And then I realized he's still got his bullshit picture.
Oh, I know exactly what I'm doing.
Yeah, I'm not, you're encouraging me not to take part in the show.
I know, I'm phasing him out.
I'm leaving that picture up.
Next week, we're not even going to Skype him, and it's just going to be a picture.
Just going to leave out the bullshit
thing. Just a picture, and that's it.
That's fucked up. That's fucked up. Chris is the lifeblood of the show. Who are you kidding?
He's the laugh lad.
Yeah, I mean, my fucking depressing ass stories. Well, I guess we all have them, right? But
yeah, we need your 230 followers, though.
If yeah, well, that's what
your
these 230 are for.
Your 230 followers result in 30 or 40 viewers, so you can suck it.
I think you're overselling Chris a little bit.
I'm really not.
Yeah.
Yo, Chris.
I'm in his streams. You know what? I'm in y'all's streams way more than either of you are in each other's streams. So,
dude, I'm in your every time you're on. Expert. Every time you're on, I'm in your stream.
No, I'm talking about Chris's stream. Oh. Chris is too late for you.
I pop in. I'm the only one that watches him and Mark play fucking Hex. I'm the only one that ever stops. Every time I stop in, I talk to them. I say hello. I'm the only one ever there.
I used to be the only one there, but.
Chris is kind of late for me. I usually check him. I usually get in on him when I'm in bed. So I stop in, say hello, and I try bullshitting for a little bit.
And then you go jack off.
I do. Do you have any stories for New Year's Eve, Chris, that you want to share or not?
Well, it's funny because it's funny, but it's not funny because I don't have a huge story to go along with it. But I did spend one New Year's Eve with a couple of trannies.
So I want to hear it.
Yeah, right.
We should end this show on a funny note. It's supposed to be a comedy show, so let's go.
Did you guys play Tummy Sticks?
Well, the thing is, like, I was in a band, and we were auditioning drummers, and...
This was the Ace of Base cover band?
The cover of Mud? Puddle of Mud?
Cover of Mud. That would be a perfect cover band name. We're called Cover of Mud. I mean, yeah. So, you know, it was a band called Adam's Evil, actually.
And... Flock of Seagulls cover band?
Oh, God damn. Motherfucker. And one of the people who showed up, her name was Carrie, and, you know, she killed it on the drums. And, you know, after we called her back another time, she's like, look, I got something to tell you. I was born a man. And we're like, okay, you know, whatever.
You're the drummer, not our girlfriend. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Can you drum? And she had just turned, like, she never got her wiener chopped off, but she got breast implants. Okay. And she went around looking like a female. And she's pretty, yeah, she's pretty convincing too. Like, she's a little bit older, so you know what happened when older women, you know, their skin starts to sag, and so it's a lot easier to transition when
they get them fucking baloney tits.
Well, I actually
saw
them.
Not if you got a boob job, they're not.
Yeah, she did get a boob job, and I actually saw them, and they were.
Was she post-op or pre-op? Did you answer that already?
She never got her wiener chopped off, ever.
So she was mid-op.
So it's
no. She's never going to get her wiener chopped.
But she got the boobs. She got the boobs done,
dude. So I'm all
like
for
mid.
That.
She's halfway. She's like from the neck down, but not from the waist down.
I don't think they should get their penis chopped off, just because. Like, I heard you never get full sensitivity back, and like you'll never experience a real orgasm again and stuff.
I don't have any idea.
She joined our band, and you know, right when she started transitioning. And it was a really difficult time for her. And we really, you know, kept her spirits up and said, look, it's great. You're a drummer. You know, you drum for us. We love you, accept you who you are, whatever. So as it happens, trannies get other tranny friends. And we ended up going to one of their houses on New Year's Eve. And we shot off a bunch of fireworks and things like that. And it was so funny. Like the other tranny was, and I say tranny, I don't mean it in a derogatory way. I mean it with
transgender.
You're just using it as a descriptor.
As a descriptor, because she would say that. Yeah. She would things like, oh, this tranny, that tranny, whatever. And she would say it just like how,
right.
You know, people of certain ethnicities. You know what I'm trying to say? Yeah. Say derogatory things to their buddies. And
I don't think tranny was derogatory when the time period you're talking. It's just.
Is it derogatory now?
Yeah, it's transgender now. Everything's transgender. You can't say trans.
It was probably
can't say transvestite.
5 years ago. Years ago when I was in this band. So, you know, we went over to their house and you know, shot off fireworks and stuff like that. The story with this other tranny, who the house that we were at, she had a dude that I guess she was married to. And she was also, like, they were in a, you know, polyamorous situation or whatever, where there was another dude or a chick involved. And it was just kind of weird. I think they eventually broke up, but it's just, you know, my whole, you know, there's a bunch of trannies involved in that period of my life, and that period's not here anymore.
You know what they call their assholes?
I'm tranny-less. I'm sorry?
They call their assholes? They're man pussies.
Man.
Chris's boob job story reminded me of one New Year's story. I went to school with a kid.
Did you get a boob job?
I did not get a boob job. But there's this kid that I went to school with from, like, literally kindergarten all the way through high school. How did that work? He must have lived not too far from me, but I lived in this, like, subdivision from the 50s. And so we were in this really quiet street, but there was a super busy road down at the end of the street, like a, you know, a thoroughfare. And I think he lived on that or maybe on another side street. But he walks into my bar on New Year's Eve, and I know how they met, but he's dating a legitimate porn star. You can look her up. She's a legitimate porn star. And Mindy Main was her porn name. Jasmine something was her real name, and I only know that because I checked her ID. I don't know what, just you made me think of this when you were talking about boob jobs and New Year's Eve. And so it's the end of the night, and I kind of had this, I had these spots where I would post up, you know, depending on what position I was feeling on the security crew that night. And so at the end of the night, I was posted up, and I was just kind of sitting there, you know, and got my arms crossed and popped my headphones out of my ear. Got my arms crossed, you know, just kind of scanning the room, watching, you know, just kind of doing this. And it's dying down. Everyone's heading back to on New Year's Eve. Most people had a package, so they got a hotel room next door as part of the package.
Package.
So pretty much nice. It was a good, you know what? Of all the bars I worked at, I'll talk the most shit about that bar, but their New Year's Eve deal was legit. Like, I worked at places where on New Year's Eve, for some reason, the cover jacked up to $20 to get in, and they did the exact same shit they did every single weekend. But at least at this place, you got dinner, a hotel, and breakfast the next day, all included, plus, you know, some drinks and snacks and stuff like that. So it was legitimately a good deal. But anyway, I'm posted up, got my arms crossed. Clay was his name. He walks up with this girl. He's drunk off his ass. He weighed like a buck 20. He was a tiny kid. He was always small. All growing up, he was small. He was a small adult. Drunk off his ass. She probably was too. I think they were with another friend. I'm trying to remember now. But I'm just sitting there, you know, I'm posted up. I'm scanning the room. And they just kind of walk up. And people that are like, that, you know, you're sort of friendly with in the bar crowd, they think, especially the drunker they get, the more best friends they think you are. So it's not uncommon when you're doing your job for somebody to like come up and sort of like be not in your face, but sort of blocking your vision and talking to you. And you just have to, you kind of gain a skill of looking around them because you got to keep doing, you got to keep working. You can't stop, you know? Yeah. And he comes up and I don't think I heard him. I don't think I was listening. I don't remember any of what he said, but next thing I knew, she takes her halter top dress and just, and obviously, you know, I was like, and then Clay's talking to me. I'm like, what? And next thing I know, bam. And I'm like, well, all right. And then she pulls it back up and they left. And I don't think I've ever seen them since.
You know,
those tits?
As part of a band, you get to see, you know, shit like that. But the worst in a bar, you know, you're playing in a bar and afterwards this drunk, you know, troll girl comes over, right?
Yeah.
And she, I swear to God, she's like 4'10" or something like that. And she had the ugliest face and she, you know, she's just sitting with her tits out. Right. And calling them tits was like generous because they were about as ugly as her face.
Oh yeah.
And she had like drumsticks, like just kind of in between her tits and like, dude, and we're all trying to load out and she's trying to get our attention. And I'm like, yeah, I'm just loading my fucking bass amp and out of here.
Like,
I gotta go.
What kind of tits are we talking? Are we talking like orangutan titties?
No. They were not large at any point in time of her life. You know, so they weren't like pancake flapjacks or anything like that. They were just like
butts.
Ish, but they're fucking ugly. Oh my God!
Well, they're those like skinny, like the tubey tits, like you know, baloney tits, like the tubey ones.
They were not. They were the opposite of that.
I can honestly say I've never seen in person breasts that I wasn't at least satisfied in seeing.
Some ugly tits out there.
I know there are. I know that they exist. I'm just saying I've never been subjected to
them. I actually just made a personal advancement in my life. The other day, I went to my phone and deleted all the titty and pussy shots that I've collected over the years.
That you've saved from the internet or that have been sent to you?
No, that's sent to me throughout the years because, you know.
Wow.
I'm just slightly too old for that. I never got any of those.
Even the girls I dated, I don't know. I always love titty shots. I always save them on my phone. I don't show everyone, but like I save them and I realize I'm not like videos. I had videos of girls sent me finger blasting themselves and shit. I realized I never go back and watch them. And then, you know, I can't go through my photos to, I'm always have to be careful. So I'm like, you know, I'm going to delete these things. Yeah. I permanently did it. 290. That was the number.
Wow.
290 different sets of tits.
None of that on it. And it's constantly telling me that it's out of space. But this guy's got 300 freaking pictures and videos of naked broads.
I'm good at getting the pictures. You know why? Because I'm not. I give back.
you send good dick pic.
I'm a great manipulator of women. Also, at least in my heyday, I was. Don't forget these are accumulative from years. These are years.
Sure, I understand.
So
I've got more years on you, and I have zero. So
let's just say I have so few. I have so few of those pictures that I don't even cringe when my wife picks up my phone.
Oh, I wish whatever. I didn't delete them. No, I was talking to this girl from Israel, Bangs, that you would get a kick out of. She was
why?
Pretty sexy.
Because she's Jewish?
Yeah. No, exactly why. Well, she's from the homeland. And we talked for a while. Well,
my ancestors are not from Israel. They're from fucking Holland.
Well, listen, I'm
mine too.
A Jew is a Jew is a Jew.
And Norway.
And I'm not trying to be insensitive, but she was like kind of hot. And I remember she lived. She had the accent and everything, and she lived with her boyfriend. But we would always have this flirtation thing. And dude, I had like 20 videos of her just fucking. She'd dance for me.
All of them and you didn't put them on the Discord.
Oh, she'd be rubbing her tits, like moaning my name.
We have a private Discord channel.
She'd be moaning my name.
It's semi-private.
People
you have
keep popping up in it. I'm like, how are you in here?
All speaking right. of which, I'm just going to ruin your story. Why some of the people on our talk show channel are not on the talk show? I'm just wondering about that.
Yeah, wasn't Derlin in there earlier?
Yeah. Derlin. And I don't have a problem with these people, but it's like, wait a minute.
What are you
Who's involved
about?
Here? Let's in see, our fucking
Yeti?
Talk show.
Kool-Aid Man.
All the mods Kirstie are in the channel. The mods have
sense.
Accents. And we gave Smarkus access because he was doing shit for us.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense. Okay, go on with your story that we don't remember anymore.
There was really no story. That was it. It was just that I had a plethora of fucking I always said I was going to make a coffee table book. You know what? I don't... Yeah, I don't miss them. I don't...
No, nor should yet. You. Nor should you.
There
I mean,
some
you've
good
had them for
fucking,
so long.
There were some
the
good
thrill,
fucking
The thrill
videos.
Is that this chick that you're talking to is sending you
Yeah, the
shit.
Thrill is getting them.
Right, when you've already got them and you're not getting her anymore, the thrill is gone. It's just depressing at that point.
Yeah, well, even you just look at him for like a day or even like, because I always ask girls for update, because it's something about getting the tit shot of you knowing that's their tits right now.
Right now, yeah.
Or that's their vagina right now.
I had one girlfriend, short relationship, that would occasionally send me stuff. But yeah, as soon as we broke up, I deleted all that shit. I didn't need it.
My problem is I don't have long-lasting relationships, so a lot of it's like one-nighters and shit like that, or just F-buddies, so I don't get that. I don't get that. Well, I don't get them anymore. A lot of these, most of these pictures are very old. Don't get me wrong, I had some that I've gotten as little as, like, last month were new ones. I'm good at getting titty shots from women.
Yeah, but you're on Tinder and all that shit, so you're like in the game right now. Chris and I are married men.
We're not
only are we out of the game, but we missed out on Tinder. I wish... And I will say this because my wife and I have talked about it. I wish I was a little bit younger, not because I want to be on Tinder. I just want to see what it's about.
I couldn't get into Tinder. I'm not on Tinder. My brother cleans up on Tinder.
I want to swipe. She was on my sister's Tinder. I don't know. Maybe it wasn't Tinder. She was on my sister's something a couple years ago. And my wife sitting there like swiping on dudes left and right.
I was doing on Christmas Day with my brother. He was on his account. We were going through. I'm like, what about that one? And like, these girls, some of them I find hot. He's like, nah. Because my brother's a good looking kid and he cleans up. So our standards are different. Like he is like me at his age. Like he's living what I did before I got fat. Like now I can't do Tinder and shit like that. I'm not a good looking guy anymore. I lost hair. I'm fat. Like I can only sell myself my personality and you can't get that across on those dating sites. You know, you have to do that in person. So, don't get me wrong. When I talk to him, like I usually get in once I get going. Cause I have a good personality, but those sites that, you know, it just comes off as you can only type and, it's a profile picture. Mm-hmm. Nah, I can't compete. I'm not a good looking man anymore.
Well, new year. It's a new you.
My chat keeps.
Chat's That's active, right. man. Chat's having a whole conversation. God bless them.
Disconnecting, so I don't see anything. I don't see anything that they're talking about. Yeah. So before we wrap up, we're running a little long. Unless you guys
No, we're running about normal for us.
Yeah, normal for us. We kept thinking, oh, we're going to do an hour and a half show, and it always turns out to be 2 hours.
When Vinny says we're running a little long, that means we have about a half hour show left. We're going to keep going for about another 30 minutes.
Yeah. Well, I think we ran through all the heavy shit. I could talk about why I didn't...
I could talk about tit pics all day.
I could talk about why I didn't have a love life in my early 20s because I was involved with a married woman. But hey, we'll save
that
for
another
show.
That's
no.
Technically a love life.
No. No, that was... No.
If we want to go dark and psychological...
You brought it up.
I can't maintain a healthy relationship because of a bad experience with my very first experience. So I can't give my heart to any woman, for the fear of being wrecked. So that's why I can never sustain a relationship. I can always get close to a woman, and we could be fuck buddies, and it can get close. Like it's all a relationship in name. We'll hang out and all that stuff. But right when it comes time to saying, "Hey, are we boyfriend and girlfriend?" I ruin it because I am so afraid to get into a committed thing because I am so afraid to get my heart wrecked again. And that's the reason. That's a psychological thing that I've worked through myself that I can't get over. There we go.
All right.
Nice to be a showstopper.
No, I...
Look, I understand. Like, yeah, it's hard to get over shit from the past. Like, I spent years and years dealing with, you know, one bad relationship. Just dealing with it in my head. And, like, it fucked me up royally. Just because the woman was manipulative and, you know... whatever. And so I mean I understand what you're talking about. It didn't affect me, I don't think, as much as yours has affected you, but yeah, I understand where you're going.
I've dated a lot, I've gone on a lot of dates, I've had a lot of sexual partners, have had a lot of good times, met a lot of fantastic women. I could probably honestly say as full-on relationships, boyfriend girlfriend together, I've only had about three. There's been women that have met my parents, and right when it comes down to, hey, you guys official, nope. I've only probably actually boyfriend girlfriend probably only about three.
It's just, you know, thing. I'll tell you the secret. When you know you got it good, when the person you're with is your friend, yeah, is also your friend. You know, yeah, you have the sex, you do all the other stuff, but it's like you just want to sit down with somebody, you know, and it's like, oh, this is my best friend too.
Yeah, no, and, I don't. I have one that I know I let go. Like, she was probably the best woman I'd ever find. Great. Just an amazing person. An amazing, sweet, beautiful, just probably the one that I should have stuck with. And we tried four times I let her go. And now she's in a happy relationship and it's serious. And it's the one I let go. That's the one that, I guess, the one that got away, I guess you'd call it. I've been kicking myself for a while about that. Yeah, she's in a very happy, beautiful relationship that I wouldn't dream of trying to get into. But yeah, that was probably the one that I fucked up. Kept pushing away. But and then we'd stop talking for about 3 to 6 months, and then I'd start talking to her again. We get close, and every time I'd apologize for fucking wrecking her, you know, I'd fucking hurt her every time. And I moved to Pennsylvania. That was the last time when I moved to Pennsylvania, and that was pretty much it. She found someone, and she's still with them. I've looked, blame me, when I got back, and yeah, they're still happy together. So,
isn't it more difficult? A lot more difficult when you get older. Like, you know, you're not in high school anymore. You know, the only way for you to meet people, like I had this thing, like I met Ona through you know, a mutual friend, and that's pretty much how it works, right? When you get older, it's like either it's someone from work or it's a mutual friend or. I mean, I could never go on the Tinders or, you know, whatever they're called.
And plenty of fish is my...
plenty of fish. Like, shit, I heard there's a bunch of fucking...
I fucking tried Craigslist at one point. That's how fucking hard up it was for me before. Because yes. That was before... I guess OkCupid was a thing. But that was bullshit. There wasn't shit going on there. And plenty of fish wasn't a thing yet. Sorry. Go ahead.
No, I'm just saying it gets difficult when you get to be older. I'm just lucky. I'm lucky I found Ona. And well, the funny, okay. So what happened was, I was living with a buddy, you know, I moved out of my mom's house when I was like 26 or something like that. I had stayed there for a long time. And you know, my buddy's like, look, dude, you need to move out. How about, you know, we got a space free, come move in with me. And it was funny because it was like me, my buddy, it's like three bedrooms with really fucking small bedrooms. It's me, my buddy, and this other guy and his girlfriend. And it was just really weird. And because it was the first time I had been out of my house. So, you know, whatever. The guy and the girlfriend left. And my buddy's like, hey, you know, my coworker, we're, this? Is that cool? And I'm like, okay, fine. And, you know, before she moved in, we had this big party, and, you know, this is the party where, you know, we're in the pool, and, you know, she basically showed me that she was interested in me by shoving her tits in my face. And it was, you know, it was great. And
worst things that could happen.
Yeah. And so basically she moved in like a week later. So we had barely been dating for like a week before she moved in with me. And well, maybe like 2 weeks or something, but regardless, it was kind of a, you know, a weird situation, but we're still together like 10 years later, 11 years. It might be 12 years, but it's been 12 years, and I've only been married six. It took me 6 years for her to ask me to marry her.
Is that what happened?
Yeah. So the story wrong is, with that. Well, we were laying in bed, and we were talking about vacation and stuff like that. And she's like, oh, we can go here. We can go here. Oh, we can go to Las Vegas. Oh, that sounds great. It's like, she's like, well, maybe we can, you know, go there and elope. I'm like, are you asking me to marry you? Nice. And she said, I guess. Yeah.
Was this after sex?
I don't think we had sex that night. Yeah, we didn't have sex that night.
He remembers every night that they've had sex. He has a list.
He puts
it in his diary.
No, for the first year, we did it every single day.
Now we're just showing off.
Now we're just showing off.
You're just showing off is my point.
Okay, now, well, you said we.
The royal we.
Oh, okay.
Jesus.
I'm
Chris. I get laid all the fucking time.
I got followers, but I wasn't playing Super Mario Maker. I have 20 people watching me.
Vinny, that's it. Chris is off the fucking show.
Let's do it.
So,
fuck with that.
You want to go back to Kool Aid?
Hold on a second. I'm getting more scotch. I'm just kidding. I have.
You want to go back to Kool Aid, man? Or you want to bring like a woman in?
Yeah,
I would like to put a woman between us. Now that you mentioned it.
Wait, what? A woman between you? Okay.
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant, goddammit.
You need a girl with big tits and cleavage to get those.
I'm on my way.
Yeah.
Fat ass is working on it.
Well, in the chat, your wife says, moving into 2 weeks isn't weird, and I'm wondering if you have a story to tell about that, Banks.
It's not really a story. She exaggerates. It wasn't 2 weeks. So I knew her. So she's, okay, wait, hold on. So there's, she has her mom and dad. Both her mom and dad split and like have been remarried multiple times, and there's kids along the way, right? So her half sister's dad and then his brothers and their wives and their kids, I all knew because they were all regulars at the bar that I worked at. And so I knew them from working. And then when I wasn't working, I'd come in, and because I was a regular at that bar before I started working there. So when I wasn't working, I'm like, well, where else am I going to go? The same place I always went. So I'd go in there and it's like, oh, it's you guys. So I ended up hanging out with them. I became really good friends with that part of the family. And so that's through them, I ended up meeting her. And then it wasn't 2 weeks. It was like 2 months probably from start to finish. But basically, she was driving past, when she get off work, she would drive past my house every day to get home. Like that was the route to her house, just as the way it worked out. And so I'd be, you know, texting her and say, hey, why don't you stop by on your way home? We'll hang out for a little bit. And then, you know, after a while, it just became, you're here all the time. And then it became, I guess you live here. And it's not really that interesting of a story. It's just the way it worked out.
I just got a message from POF, actually, now that we speak, that says, new singles in your area. Message them now with First Look.
Pull it up. Let's see it.
No. They're listening to your talk show right now, and they're like, oh.
Fuck it. You know what? We should do a Tinder show. We should just put, instead of our faces, we'll put up three feeds, and we'll all sit there and swipe, and everyone will get an idea of what we find attractive.
Chris is in.
If I'm allowed to do it, I'll fucking do it.
I don't think I want to show everyone.
I just said you could do it. Whose permission do you need, Chris? I just said you could do it.
I don't want to show everyone all my rejection.
No. We're showing you rejecting people.
No, yeah, you're the one who's choosing.
You're the one doing the rejecting.
Rejecting. Like, you're basically showing us what girls that you would swipe left and swipe right.
You know what Vinny would do, too? Swipe right means you like them, right? Is that right?
I don't fucking know.
So he'd swipe right on the ones with good personalities. He would swipe left on all the fucking models. He'd be like, nah, nah, I ain't into that. Nah.
What we should do, what we should do is just have one person, right, have the phone on there, and then we all, like, vote. And then whoever gets the majority, we're going to swipe left or right. We're going to do it for Vinny.
No. I'm not doing that to a bunch of strangers. I'm not gonna put up to a democratic vote the attractiveness of strangers. That's fucking.
I always wanted to make two profiles, one with me and one that's just the same fucking profile, but just with a better looking guy, and just to show how shallow women are on that those sides.
Well, but everybody's shallow in the beginning.
Well, that's true.
Everybody is.
Listen, those sites are bad though. Like. I don't want this to turn into a sexist thing, but it's weird because I always hear from women that I do talk to off them, guys are very creepy on there, and I'm not creepy at all. I'm a straight up gentleman. I'm a sweet guy. But the women I get rejected, sometimes I just feel sad and want someone to talk to, so I'll message a real fucking piece of work, and yeah. I see that they looked
good
at
enough.
Yeah, they looked at my profile and moved on. Like, I know from women That's who I owe up. Personally in life who join those sites, and they're. It's right. It's shallow because you'll never, unless you're a good looking guy, you'll never really meet someone off those sites because I think I said this in my, well, we were talking about this on my channel before. It's because even if they message you and start talking to you, their profile's still active. So they're eventually going to be getting more messages because women get messages hell of a lot more than guys. And there's always going to be someone better than you who's going to message them. And they're just going to blow you off.
Women on those sites, they have 100 responses no matter what.
And they're on that site. They're on that site. Half of them are on that site for a fucking reason. It's because they are shallow. Or
free dinner.
Yeah. Well, I know a girl who actually literally does that. She just goes on dates for free meals and her good time. I don't know. Like, I'm not friends with her. I know of her, though. She's a real piece of shit.
I mean, let's say you're a girl and you want to get laid. You could basically go on Tinder and pick and choose the guys you want.
Tinder is more of a, from what my brother tells me, Tinder is more of just the hookup.
That's just hookup, right? Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And sometimes a hookup leads to a relationship, but it's everyone on there is looking for a hookup.
Yeah. Yeah, and I'll say people don't find happiness through them. Like, I know people who have met on there. I'm just saying for the most part. And not, like I said, not all people are, I'm saying overall, like, don't take everything I say for like, oh, this is this. It's like an overall this. And this is from years of fucking research.
This has all been a scientific endeavor for Vinny.
Yeah, pretty much, because I've tried different approaches. I've probably tried so many different approaches between just being a sweet guy, an asshole, a fucking piece of shit, lying, not lying. It's all the same. But I don't know, whatever. So we are actually running a little long now. Before we go, I want to ask you guys what you guys are hoping for, or expecting, or wish for 2017. Chris?
2017. I think my problem is, my biggest problem is I live in the moment. So I never plan. I'm completely the opposite of Bangs. I don't plan for shit. I live paycheck to paycheck. I blow my money on things that make me happy right now. So you're asking me about plans in the future. I don't live in the future, dude. I live right now. And what I hope to have happen, I mean, I've been at the same job for like 20 years. So I don't want that to change because I get paid so much for not having a degree. Like, I could probably make more if I had a degree, but like, geez Louise, man, I just, you know, I started as a typing job and it worked up and worked up and worked up. So if I left my job now, I'd be making, you know, half as much if I was lucky. So as far as a career goes, I'm like, I'm okay. You know, I'm doing fine. And so I'm not looking forward to a career change. You know, I like Twitch. I want to see where this is going. You know, the fact that I'm moving away from one game into other games and people are accepting that blows my mind. You know, the fact that I've made lots of friends here, it's amazing. So I don't know if I have many plans. I have some, you know, I want things to keep going kind of like the way they are. I want to get, you know, I would like to be a person who started planning things a little bit more and, you know, maybe balance my
bank account a little bit better and things like that. You know, we want to go, we're going to go on a vacation, you know, hey, we don't have money, but we're going to go on a vacation to, to Yellowstone and,
maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe. Maybe.
I'm trying to bail you out here, Chris.
Oh,
I'm
in the chat. Yeah, yeah.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to keep putting it in her and we'll see what happens.
Have you ever seen, I think I asked this question before. Have you ever seen the movie or the play Hurley Burley?
No, you've never asked me that and I've never seen it.
Okay. It's a little long, but it's really good. And it's a David Mamet play. They turn it into a movie, but the movie is like Kevin Spacey and Sean Penn and Chaz Palminteri and all this stuff. Tons of A-list actors in this. And there's this bit where Chaz Palminteri is talking about, he's like got this, he's on his like third wife or something and she's way younger and she wants to have a baby. And Sean Penn's like, so, you know, you're like, you know, you're using the condom. He's like, no, man, I'm taking something that's, you know, I'm taking care of it. He goes, what do you mean you're taking care of it? I'm taking some stuff that's taking care of it. What do you mean you're taking care of stuff? I'm saying I'm taking care of something that's harmful to the sperm. So she can't get pregnant. I'm taking something that's harmful to the sperm. Anyway, just made me think of it. He was taking a pill that was supposed to keep him from pregnant.
I love Kevin Spacey, so I'll
check it out.
Chris, you do know you have to put your penis.
Fuck both of you guys.
You do know you have to put your penis.
Because I'm culture to watch movies that are a step above fucking Suicide Squad. I'm the asshole.
Oh! All of a sudden, cheap shot here.
I always watch the one I can think of in the moment that are on the list for best movie. You know you have to put your penis in her vagina to get her pregnant, right?
What? Shut up! That's been his anal angle this whole time, Vinny. Fuck.
Sorry.
You're the anal one that gave them angle. Pointers on how to do it.
You could have an ass baby. Yeah.
Ass baby. We call that a pho baby over here. When you've had too much pho and you gotta
pho?
It's a Vietnamese beef noodle soup, but it destroys you. Yeah, you're gonna spend some time in the bathroom. Between the peeing from the broth and then the eventual gut bomb from all the like starch and protein. Yeah. Call that a pho baby.
Will you name your first child after me?
No, this is a funny story. So, Ona was doing our family tree.
Well played.
was doing our family tree, and we basically she did my side, and she found out that the first Hansen that came into the United States his name was Hans.
You're not naming your kid Hans.
Hans Hansen.
You're not going to give your kid the name Hans. That's child abuse. Your name's already Chris Hansen. You're not going to name your kid Hans.
Yeah. But it would be funny, right? It would be great.
To us, not to the kid who's going to get bullied for 18 years.
Hans Hansen.
Hans Hansen?
It was the last name probably came from the fact that his name was Hans and he was like the son of Hans or something, you know what
I mean? Probably. That's probably where Hansen came from. You're right.
Yeah. So Ona says no. Well, but it was a funny joke for a little while, so you know, whatever, we'll figure it out once you know the baby decides it wants to be a baby.
Just name the kid Batman. All right, you can't go wrong.
Okay, Batman. What if it's a girl?
Okay. Coolest kid. Doesn't matter. You know what? It's 2016. Gender roles are outdated, Chris. Okay? Oh. Girls can be Batman if they want to. Okay? Fucking backwards, freaking outdated shitbag. Anyway, name it Batman.
Okay. So that's what I'm looking forward to 2017. More success with Twitch.
Fascinating.
And spending money that I don't have. So how about you, Banks?
Definitely would like success in Twitch. But I feel like such a jackass saying I want to be successful. We talk about, so on my stream, we talk about, like, I call it inside baseball, and we've done it on this stream or on the talk show many times, but I call it inside baseball. We're like sort of behind the curtain kind of stuff and just sort of talking about the things that I think about. So we've had numerous conversations about quote unquote success on Twitch. I definitely want more success. I don't know that it has to be on Twitch, but definitely in some entertainment medium. that might have been where I was going when I talked about wanting to be a Hollywood writer and director. I definitely have always wanted to be in entertainment, but not in like, I never wanted to be an actor. I never wanted to be the performer. I wanted to be the voice. You know what I mean? I think that's why I like Twitch, because I'm theoretically the voice. Well, I'm the voice of my stream.
Oh, your stream. Your stream.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So I guess when I say I want more success in Twitch, what I want is, I mean, you definitely want more viewers, not because I want more viewers, but because I want more people participating in the conversation. Vinny and I talk about this all the time. Like, for me, my stream's not about the game I'm playing. I could give two shits about the game I'm playing. The right. game is supposed to bring people in. And since I stopped playing Mario Maker and there's fewer people watching, people are coming in to watch the game. They're not coming in to interact necessarily. And it can be really brutal from a difficulty standpoint to, like, for me to be invested in the stream when I'm just playing the game. You know, when there's not a conversation, some sort of dialogue going. I'm trying to do better about that myself. But to me, success in Twitch is sort of having a string of days, you know, a string of streams going where there's dynamic conversations going. So I definitely want that. I guess I'm gonna have to go find a job, I guess, because I can't keep not working. And at this point, we've kind of decided the bar is probably a good idea that it didn't work out. And then maybe we need, because we're starting to realize that not we don't want to be hermits, but we want to definitely disconnect from the establishment a little bit. You know what I mean? We want to be self-sufficient and not rely on the system to provide for us, so to speak. You know? So it's one thing to have electricity coming in and the internet coming in and maybe cable coming in. But like we're talking about a farm. Like, we want to grow our own food. We want to be as self-sufficient as possible, you know?
Be off the
grid. So that's a goal for 2017/2018.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, I guess I'm going to have to find a job. And at this point, I would settle for not for 20. If 2017 is not a complete catastrophe, then I'll call that a win. Vinny?
Can I move to your farm and be your stable boy?
Yes. You know, I think I have an interview next week to run a retail location. And I was funny because I was thinking about it. I'm like, you know what? I bet Vinny would be really good at this. So
what, running a retail location?
No. Sales, doing sales. Oh.
Yeah, I'm bad at sales, man. I'm bad at selling people bullshit. I'm too honest. No. I'm too honest. Now, if it's a product...
I was a bill collector for 14 years. I was honest the whole time. I never lied anything.
Now, if it's a product I believe in, oh, that's easy. But, I mean, you're just telling here, sell this piece of shit, I can't be a car salesman. But, like...
Well, you could if you believe in the car. But this is all hypothetical because I haven't done anything. But, I don't know. They've been calling me, and it sounds like it might be something, but it's a cell phone store.
Oh, nice. Oh, yeah. I remember you telling me something about that, I think. For me in 2017, well, when we started the show saying how it's been a bummer of a year, I would think it can only go up. 2016 has been the year of me making bad decisions. As someone who's prided myself on thinking things through, making good decisions, not jumping onto something without a plan, trying to be three steps ahead, this is the year I took risks, and zero of the risks paid off.
I hear that.
So that scares me, because like I'm not a big risk taker. I've always been a guy who like is like, oh, should we do this, thinker. Well, I tried the risk thing and none of it took off. Now what scares the fuck out of me is the difference between 2016 and 2017 is nothing. It's a number. It's nothing.
Yeah.
It's nothing. Psychologically, it seems like a whole new beginning, a fresh start, but it's not. It's another day. But without being a downer, very generic. I would like to work on myself, my mental state, my body. I'm the heaviest I've ever been in my entire life, and that's very I think that leads to a lot of my depression.
Yeah.
The Twitch thing's one thing. I don't know. Fuck Twitch. But
I agree with that too, oddly enough.
No, I feel you with the viewerships and wanting it to work and all that stuff. I thought, I truly believe that I'd be a little bit more successful at it by this time than I am. Now, don't get me wrong. I could be this far in and have 100 followers, or I could be streaming to no one every day. The fact that I never have a stream where I'm streaming to no one, you know, it's usually between
something.
It's usually between 10 to 20 on a general day. I really wish that growth would have improved, but whatever. So on that front, same as you, career-wise, it would be nice to find a career. I want to start my life. I feel like I know everyone around me is telling me I'm still young, and a lot of people don't figure things out until later on in their 30s and all that stuff, where to me, I feel like I'm old and that I'm a loser and I haven't got my shit together. I want that. Like, I want a career. I want to jumpstart my life. I want to fucking, I thought I had freedom. I had freedom. I had it. I fucked up. I was in a good career. I wanted more. I became cocky. I could have been comfortable with what I was making. Yeah, I wasn't happy with the profession, but I could have stuck it out. I was on my own. I was in a different state. I could have met someone. Not to bring this back, but like it's crazy because I left for something else that didn't work out. And I thought, oh, I could find a job making what I'm making or close to it. The reality of what the average salary is from what I was making is just my mind just fucking... I don't know how to explain it. My mind's just fucking blown. That I thought I'd be okay. Like, even if that didn't work out, I'd find something that around the same. The difference between what I can get to what I was making is so astronomical. I just didn't know that was the reality of life right now. But anyway, I'm getting off track. But yeah, health. I want to improve myself, career, and dare I say, maybe down the road, love. Who knows? But that's 2017 for me, I hope.
I hope so, too.
Thank you. I hope we all get what we want.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hope we can all circle jerk. And everyone who follows us. I love the one thing, great thing about the year, which I think you guys would agree with me, which we already talked about this stream, is for better or worse, Twitch has been a good thing for us. We met a lot. We met each other. We met some great people.
Great people.
Friends, like legit friends 100%. That we would have never had if it wasn't for Twitch. So
that's been my hard break with Super Mario Maker, because all of those friends I met through Super Mario Maker.
Yeah,
you know, so it's like but
the real friends are the ones that still come, though.
Right.
I mean, who knows? Maybe Mario Maker's on its way out anyway. I mean, it kind of feels that way, but you know, as the
community on Twitch totally is, no question about it.
We could spend an hour on it, but yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
It's a dying community.
And you talk about Twitch like not being the end all be all. I mean, it could be just a stepping stone, and we can meet more other cool people on another platform. Or, you know, when you're an entertainer, it's more about who you are and not about where you're broadcasting from.
Right.
You know, who the fuck knows where Howard Stern's broadcasting from? 95% of the people don't, and they don't care.
It's the exposure. You know? You need the exposure.
Yeah.
I strongly believe that any of three of us could be just as good as anyone. We don't have the exposure. You know, this is getting a little bit behind the scenes. I don't want to point any names or call any, which I don't want to do that because I hold no grudges against anyone on Twitch. But some people you do see that are a little bit bigger or have gotten bigger recently. It's not because they're good streamers. People like them for whatever reason, and they have a good team around them. Mm-hmm. You know, all of a sudden, you know, they partner up, and all of a sudden they're getting those fucking mass raids, and that's all it takes. Any one of us could be just as big as anyone. It's all about, you know, sharing the community. You get those raids. We can talk all we want in other people's chats and stuff, but if they're not spreading the love over, or not that, you know what I mean. I'm not saying you could build your own.
No, you're 100% correct. Yeah.
Twitch is all about, no matter how good or bad you are, it's all about the exposure.
Yeah.
Well, it's also about who you know. I've noticed that more now than everywhere. Yeah,
that's what I'm talking about.
It's like who you fucking know, and yeah, exactly what you're talking about. And yeah.
Because there are some people that are just god awful fucking streamers. I'm not saying we're amazing streamers. I'm just saying we could be just as bad as them, but they're big enough that it's like, how did that happen? It's because they get the exposure. And hey, God bless them. You know, it's what they want to do.
I'm willing to say that we're at least above average.
Yeah, I mean, come on. I'm happy.
I mean, I'll only speak for myself. I only do the show with you guys because prior to us doing the show, I was a huge fan of your streams. And then we became friends and we decided to do a show together.
I don't know how I met Chris. It had to be through you because I didn't meet Chris. I didn't discover Chris.
I don't remember how I met Chris either. I mean, Vinny found my stream when I first started playing Mario Maker. And Chris, are you sitting down? He was like super nice and polite and friendly and normal.
I am that everyone's
streamer too. And I was like, I'll come check you out. And we come through the next day and I was like, oh, babe, Vinny's streaming. Let's go watch him. And she, of course, you know, she's like, who's Vinny? Because we just met him. Like, the guy from last night that was super friendly. She's like, oh, let's go watch. And, you know, it was Vinny. It was Vinny's stream. But we had that sense of humor, so we fucking loved it. And we've been great friends ever since.
I don't go into anyone's stream, start talking ass and pussy. I'm polite.
Right. No, exactly. But more than that, Chris, Vinny was like teaching, because I had just gotten Mario Maker. Just gotten it. And he was teaching me how to do, like, bomb ladders and, like all kinds of, like, not Kaizo, but like light Kaizo shit.
I got you on OBS Studio, I think.
You did get me on OBS Studio. He was coaching me through all of this shit, just like super friendly and awesome. And, you know, and not that he's not friendly and awesome, but it was like Vinny without the pussy and the ass part, you know? So it's almost a different person. I don't remember how I met Chris.
I was a viewer of yours.
Were you?
Yeah,
oh, those were the good old days, you son of a bitch.
Don't you remember when I told you that when I first started streaming, I used you as an influence as far as how I conducted myself?
Now that you mentioned
myself?
I do remember that. I do remember that.
Yeah, think about how much...
Now the student has surpassed the master.
Think about how much better and bigger you'd be if you used me as an influence.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You'd be off Twitch.
Listen.
You say bigger, you mean like physically.
Yes.
If there's one thing 2016 has taught me, is that any disillusions I had about being a good entertainer have been crushed, and I am a shitty fucking streamer. So,
oh, come on. No, yeah. I have a story about Vinny. Like, I'm looking back at my first message I got from Vinny, and it was I was told to come here. How is everyone? And I said, wait, what? You're whispering me.
Was he fucking Leech now? He doesn't talk in chat.
So he replied, good call, LOL. What's up, Kristopher? I'm fucked up right now. That's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it.
That's probably a Xanax.
It's probably Xanax.
I said, nice, good to meet you. I believe I've seen your stream. Good stuff. And he says, oh, awesome, man. Glad to hear it. And then...
This is in your whispers? Is that why you still
this
have
is
that?
This is the first whisper conversation I had with Vinny.
Now I'm fucking curious.
I was about to end the show.
It was so hilarious. Like that was my first like ever talking to Vinny. Like
my anything. Private whispers are I'm a very polite person in real life. I only put on this.
You're a polite person
character.
All the time.
Oh,
yeah,
definitely.
Yeah, I put on. Yeah, it's a little bit of a character. It's a heightened sense of me. What are we doing?
Like I remember Bangs. Like when I.
Apparently,
when I said
Chris,
that,
we're still supposed to. We've never done Smash. Apparently, we were supposed to do Smash 4 at some point.
Oh, let's do that. Like,
you know what?
Oh, no, I did. I did with you.
You did?
I think once because you were talking about how inexperienced you were because you hadn't really played the game and you were learning the buttons.
I haven't played Smash 4, but maybe twice.
Yeah, yeah. And you were telling me, and I was kicking your ass, and you're like, okay, well, this is done. And maybe that was, I believe that was you. I'm not positive, but we should do it. Maybe not. I mean, if you're
bad,
then
thanks a lot for taking part in my Smash Sunday. So you apparently had a thing. I'm listening to playback, blah, 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 blah. You're putting me over on Whisper.
Putting you over?
You were complimenting me. It's in wrestling. It's called putting me over.
Okay. Sucking your dick. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Sucking my dick. Anyway, sorry.
Anyway. No, it's interesting looking back at you know.
Well, it's weird because you know, like I met both of you guys like August ish of this year, and it feels like we've known each other for so much longer than that. It's only been like 3 months, 4 months.
Well, it feels like I've been streaming a lot longer than I have been.
Weird.
All right,
I've only been streaming since August.
We've done sucking each other's dicks.
No. I don't know. There's a few drops left.
I'm looking up Vinny now. I want to see what conversations I've had with him.
We've had a lot of private
conversations. I don't think ours have been on Whisper, though.
Well, we've had a lot of private conversations, so I would like you not to air those out.
No, I wouldn't air them out. I was looking for funny things. I was just looking for my own edification, because now Chris has me interested.
Yeah, see? So, that's how we met.
Our first private one is probably thanking you for Save Vinny's Ass donation.
Probably.
That was, like, the first fucking stream you came to.
So, Chris, did you find my stream? Do you remember? Did you find my stream just looking at the channel? The Mario Maker channel?
Yeah, definitely.
Huh. Because I could have only had a handful of viewers at that time.
Yeah, no.
Just got Mario Maker.
Chris was a level dumper, and he just wanted to look for a short queue.
I don't even know that he was at the time.
I was.
He's a level dumper now, but... Yeah, you're right. You're right, Vinny. It was the very first Whisper was a thank you for contributing to the Save Your Ass Fund.
Nice. I always thank people privately for donations. Everyone I get, if it's a dollar or more.
That's a good idea. I wish I was better about that.
I haven't actually thanked anyone through Whisper.
I think I thank everybody, but
literally every donation I ever get, I shoot a private message out, private thank you message.
I go on a 5-minute thing on stream, and then
that's
it's
what
done.
I do.
Well, I do both.
Like, oh, great, you're so amazing.
I'm a better person than you guys.
You are. So. That's a fact.
Yeah. Yeah.
I never expected the type of generosity I've gotten since I started streaming. Don't get me wrong. It's not like I'm making millions of dollars or anything. But to be a shitty small streamer like me and to... be able to not just have last donation on screen, but I have a fucking scroll of donations is really moving to me. I'm not even talking about any form of money, just a fucking dollar. The fact that anyone would donate me a dollar for the shit show product that I put on. has been
Michelle in the chat, my wife, said she was the one that contributed to the Save Vinny's Ass Fund.
Yo, that Save Vinny's Ass Fund was fucking
That is
crazy.
Correct.
Because you figured out, correct. I had half the followers I had now, and like Derlin, how are you? He just showed up. He fucking was a fucking donator. Like,
well, I watched it. You.
The fact that
raised like $400 in less than a month.
Yeah, that was insane. That was fucking insane.
I've been trying to raise, you know, $200 for like 3 months. To buy a new chair.
I'm more likable than you. What could I say?
You are, apparently. Like, I'm not even arguing with you. Apparently, I'm a shitty streamer.
I've gotten $10 in about six boxes of beans.
$5, that was from me, though. And I was your first dono.
You were. I almost about dropped my pants. And
if Mark had been there, you would have.
And I'm gonna get a helicopter.
I'm gonna get an Amazon wish list.
Nice.
I'm gonna get an Amazon wish list, and it's just gonna be a whole bunch of like ladies' panties.
Oh, by the way, everyone, I've updated my Amazon gift list. So if you would like to,
stream. You know what? I've never in my life wanted to be a woman until I experienced Twitch. I'm like, if I had been born a chick.
Oh yeah,
I would be fucking milking this shit all day long.
Oh my god, I would be such a webcam girl. I'd be such a whore.
I would do all the shit that I criticize. I would do all of it.
Oh yeah.
Every low down, no pride, all that shit. Hi guys. I would have the whiteboard and the fucking yoga pants, and I'd have the Amazon wish list with the buy me these panties and I'll wear them for you on stream. I would do all that shit. Yeah. No shame in the game. Listen, people come onto my stream all the time. Like, what do you think of gamer girls and cam girls? Aren't they shitty? Fuck no, they're brilliant.
Yeah.
Those girls are fucking brilliant. Their viewers are dumb as shit, but those girls are fucking geniuses, and I'm jealous of every one of them.
I hate the game, not the player.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, I would.
I was going to tell you.
If I was a chick that looked like me, I would still do it. Yeah, I would still do it. I'd be on Chatterbait. I'd be on all of it.
Because there's still a chubby chaser.
I would be spreading my pussy lips so far.
If it's literally you with boobs, there's still a guy who's into that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Think of the girl I was talking about 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
I would be spreading my asshole so wide on camera.
There was a... I was watching this one Twitch chick. who had a had an Amazon donation list, right? And yeah. I told you guys this story offline. But, you know, I clicked on it because it was on her profile. She's like, hey, if you want to donate, you can buy me something off this Amazon thing. And I looked at it, and the top thing on there was a fucking vibrator.
Yeah. And, well, A, those things are fucking expensive, number one. Bad and number dragon. Two, she could probably get a guy to buy it for her.
Well, the funny thing is, I was like, oh, I chatted to her. I'm like, that's really interesting, the thing on your thing. And she clicked on it on her list, and she got all red, and she immediately removed it because she put it on the wrong list. So she was
I don't believe her.
You don't believe her? But no. She wouldn't have removed it.
Yes, she would have. I don't believe her. Look,
she
maybe,
probably put it
okay,
back
maybe.
On.
Listen, maybe. Maybe that's legit. I don't believe her. I don't believe her. Because here's the thing. That shit, that resonates with the white knight motherfuckers so hard. And they'd be like, oh, we got to protect the... Look, I've been guilty of it as much as anybody. But we go, we got to protect her. Oh, we're not even going to talk about it. If anybody comes in and says anything, we're going to fucking attack them because we're going to defend our this girl that we're totally not trying to fuck. We're just fans of hers. I was a mod for a stream that's hosted by a woman who some people find attractive. I've been in the role, and I don't find her attractive personally. I've told you guys, I like looked at her like a little sister, not like a sex object.
Oh, I know you're talking.
And you have dudes come in, and they're like da 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 da, you know, trying to be assholes, and like you fucking run to defend her. So that maybe it was an accident, and maybe she's embarrassed. But you know what? I'm gonna call bullshit because who fucking puts a vibrator on their wish list, regardless of whether it's personal, private, or whatever? Like you're gonna forget that you wanted a vibrator? You put shit on your wish list so you remember to go back and buy it.
I know you're talking about.
For you.
I personally don't find her attractive either.
I know you don't. That's fine.
I don't go
to the stream anymore, so it doesn't fucking
matter. I don't mind. I don't.
Mod. Doesn't matter.
I've never been as sexist as I am, as much as I talk. I have never been one of those guys that will go into a chat and just overly flirtatious and shit like that and just suck their twat. That's not who I am. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, Chris. No, you get what I'm saying? Like, I don't get those horny guys that are like, oh, you're not going to get her. She's not going to show special favors to you.
Yeah.
I don't know. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no,
I know exactly what you're saying.
No, 100%. Yeah. You see it a lot in the indie wrestling, man. A lot of these women on the indies, they all have Amazon wish lists, and they'll have, I mean, for them, it's ring gear, right? But they're all wearing, you know, vinyl or some derivative of for you know, ring gear. Like the shit they wrestle in. So they'll put the shit up on Amazon, you know, because everybody's, whether you're Amazon or you're a third party seller, it's available through Amazon, right? So they'll have wish lists, you know, 10 pages deep of what to a normal person is lingerie or, you know, S&M, BDSM shit, you know, leather and vinyl and chains and blocks and hooks and whips and other shit. But to them, it's, you know, their costume, right? They'll put that shit up there all the time on their Amazon wish list, and they'll promote it all day long on Twitter, and they'll get people sending them shit all the time off there. You know, hundreds and thousands of dollars worth of product. And they wear it once.
Yeah.
And they wear it once. They do their show. I get it. Like, I mean, they are legitimately using it in their show, and then they sell the shit on eBay as ring worn shit. So, as Vinny would say, it smells like the nasty pussy.
Yeah.
Hey, can I show you guys something?
I'm not mad at him. I would do it too.
Is it your dick?
If there was a market for me with it, you know, you made a joke when during pre-show, I realized I was wearing a shirt that I'd been cleaning house in all day. I said, I got to change my shirt. And Chris says, you know, something like show us your nipples or something. If taking my shirt off would make me $2, I would do it today.
Oh yeah. That'd be such a fucking, part of me wants to try to pass as like a really butch lesbian.
I did this last show.
How is your chest so bare?
You're going to get us thrown off.
How do you do that? Right here. That's hair. Way far down. Look at this. I'm like, maybe you can't see. I got hair like at my fucking Adam's apple. How do you do that?
I don't know.
We talked about this before. We were joking about it. But if you gave me the figures, if the money was right, I would so do gay phone sex. I have no shame in it at all. If I knew it was going to make me some good money, I don't have a problem telling a guy how much I want to suck his dick and swallow his load on the phone.
No.
I have no shame.
It's just talking. I mean, it's
I'm a Jew. If I'm getting paid for it, there's not a lot I won't do.
It has to be gay. I obviously I would prefer doing straight talk, but there's no money in that. Women aren't calling guys.
No, no woman's calling you to have you talk about how you get.
No, because guys are
fucking.
They're
going to go and actually get their pussy licked.
Guys are disgusting perverts and just they'll do anything to get off. But
my wife's in the chat saying she'll give me $2. We don't have $2. That's the reason I'm willing to do it for $2.
She'll give you $2 of Bitcoin stuff. She'll give you
she'll give me $2 from
$2 worth of loving.
Yeah, I'll give you $2 in sprinkles.
No thanks.
My fake stream currency that no one
uses. I'll give myself $2 in shekels. My shekels are worth less than your sprinkles. At least I can buy a fucking song request with your sprinkles.
Yeah.
Don't think you
I have sound bits.
Them.
I have sound bits. No
you
one uses
fucking
them.
Guys in your fucking stream currency.
I didn't want to do it.
Chris, real talk, don't get sucked into it. A bunch of fucking teenagers convinced me to get currency, and they were there every day, and I said, okay, fine, I'll get you guys currency, and I got it set up, and you know what? School started, ain't seen them since. I got this fucking currency system that doesn't mean anything, and I don't have any ideas for it, and there it sits.
I was talked into it, too, and it was kind of like when the stream was happening.
It's such a waste of time. Every stream I go into, there's only, you know what? There is one streamer whose currency system I get, and I don't mean to put him over, but it's Lucid Fox.
Yes.
And
yes.
You take the currency, and anyone, you can do whatever. You can keep it, you can accrue it, you can gamble it, or you can put it in this like investment system he has. And when you reach a certain point, he does something. If it's like a 24-hour stream, or it's we're going to play this game. And so people can waste their currency on things for the show. And it basically is no skin off his back. You know what I mean? It's content for his stream. That's the only use of the currency I've ever seen that makes any sense.
I got talked into it too. And the only thing, like, I was using it more in the beginning. I was using it a lot for song requests, so you didn't get like bombarded with just bad people coming in, you know, submitting things. And I used to do, when I first did the sprinkle system, I would I was doing a lot of Steam game giveaways. So to enter the raffle, so someone could have just come in, enter a raffle, and then win. Who's not?
Yeah. And you had all those giveaways early on, so that makes sense.
But yeah, I don't fucking use it anymore. I was doing the casino thing, the exclamation point casino, and that was fun.
I have that, but
I haven't updated them in a while. A lot of it was just, but I had a lot of stupid ass fucking scenarios.
But and the funny thing is, I think it's just a maturity in Twitch. But I was into the currency thing. Like, I was all about, like, accruing it and, you know, growing it and being, you know, because you have the top 10. Like, oh, I'm at the top. Da, 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 da. And then I got there on certain streams, and I was like, and I just gave it all away. And then I worked my way back up, and then I was like, this is fucking stupid. So, you know, so if you figure, I started watching Twitch when Mario Maker came out. That was what got me into Twitch. I wanted to check this game out. And I watched a couple of channels that actually used currency, like your currency accrued so slowly that they actually used it in interesting ways. It doesn't matter, but they use it in ways that it made sense. And then sometime around the first year, I think Mario Maker on Twitch started to blow up. And so you had all these new streamers coming in, and they all had currency systems. And so as I started watching them, I realized I had all of these fake currencies that they didn't do anything for the stream. And so once I made it to the top by like the second or third time, I was like, this is the dumbest fucking thing I've ever seen in my life. I didn't care anymore. And the funny thing about it, because you laugh, but that was before I instituted my own currency system. Fucking, I hate it. I want to delete, because it's an extra bot. I have Revlo bot. I don't even remember who told me about it, but I have a separate bot its only function is the currency system. That's all it does, and I want to blow it up so bad. Yeah. But I watch people. But there's people that come in, and people that I don't see. You know, I'm not calling them out. But there's, like, for instance, Vernal Equinox, who's a guy I've known on Twitch for better part of a year, and he's always been very supportive when I see him in other streams. You know, he's a super cool guy. I've seen actually recently he's been streaming as well. He isn't an active participant in my stream necessarily, but I see him come in fairly regularly. He comes in, he gambles his shekels for probably an hour, and then, you know, he bounces out. But it, like, it brings him in, you know, consistently, and I'm like, Do I blow this thing up or do I just leave it? Because it's not doing, it's like, it's irrelevant to me, but if it means something to somebody else, maybe I should leave it. I don't know.
No, because they could do that in any stream. You got to be
yes,
here
but if
for
they want to do it
in
mine, well, that's true. For that's you. The dichotomy. That's no, you're right, Chris. That's the dichotomy, though, is that, and it's the same thing with Mario Maker. When I was playing Mario Maker, I was on my way up. I was doing 30 to 40 concurrent viewers when I quit. Well, when I was forced to quit playing Mario Maker. You know what I mean? And it's like, do you, and now I'm doing like on a good day, 15, right? You know, do
that's
you,
good.
It is good. And I'm happy with it. And honestly, the 15 people that I have watching me now are way more involved. I don't want to misconstrue it. I'm not complaining. The 15 people that I have watching right now are so much more involved and dedicated than the 40 people I had before. Do not misunderstand me. But
yeah.
if this currency system that means nothing to me means something to somebody else, maybe I leave it. You know, I don't know.
I'm too lazy to take
I mean,
it
it's
off.
Not hurting anything, really.
Right, right now. And as I keep saying, there's a guy named Dastern who's writing. He does a creative stream and he's writing a new bot. I've talked to you about this, Chris.
Yes,
he's programming a new bot, and it's going to have all that shit integrated. So I'm kind of waiting for that bot to come out and maybe transferring everything over to that, and then maybe finding something fun and useful to do with the currency. But anyway.
Well, I have a whole list on shit you could do with currency, but no one looks at them. I have a whole, like, exclamation point thing, and I have sound effects, which no one play because we're in the middle of a talk show. But hey, guys, we went really long tonight, and I know we were talking, but it wasn't a good show,
yeah,
and we went really long for a bad show.
We're running out of time.
And you guys made me miss the entire Michigan-Florida State game, which Michigan ended up losing 33-32, which sucks, but it would have been a good game. So
Chris is in the Discord. He keeps using the wrong fucking channel.
Oh, shit.
You oh, did shit. It earlier, too. I was like, oh, shit. Dumbass. We have a private channel for this shit. He's in the public channel, but whatever. Fuck it. Since when does anything we do go correctly?
Oh, you deleted it.
Yeah,
you're deleting it, aren't you?
That's embarrassing. Fuck.
Yeah,
fuck,
sorry.
You're such an embarrassing.
Just delete the whole. I'm gonna delete this one.
Can I? The picture? No.
Yeah, I can't.
No,
not
leave
the picture. There we go.
All right, boys.
I'm
an
idiot.
Let's end it.
Fucking idiot.
This was a long ass show. This is the longest one we've ever done, and it was far
is
from
it?
Our best show. Yeah,
three
dude, we're almost at 3 hours.
Almost.
And it's
here.
Midnight. There's stuff I need to do.
Yeah, masturbate.
Yep.
I'm not judging. I'm just statement of fact.
I'm gonna go back to watching. I'm gonna go back to watching Penny Dreadful and watch some dirty fucking.
I'm gonna try and get some vanilla ice cream to go with my raspberry jalapeno jam.
You've been drinking that Coke, and for some reason I want a soda now. I don't have any soda in my house.
And I haven't even I've got a little bit more than half of it that I drank.
I want cold flat soda. Is that weird?
Come on
cold
over.
Flat
this
soda.
Is what this is. It's
for some
got
reason
my
I want
on it.
Cold flat soda.
You know what's funny is I never when you. I was a kid I hated diet soda. But my mom would get, we had these tall, like they were Tupperware cups, and they were tall and they were kind of, you can't see, they were kind of narrow. And oh, I am sorry. I had a stream going on over here and I realized they just hosted somebody that I absolutely will not watch under any circumstances. Anyway, she used to fill it up to the top with ice and she poured Diet Pepsi over it. And then she would take a sip and it would sit there, and she put it on the table, and she would walk away. And it would sit there for like 20 minutes, and the ice would start to melt. And like you were saying, Vinny, it was cold, and it would get flat. And inevitably, I would end up drinking it, and it was like my favorite thing growing up was flat, cold Diet Pepsi.
I like diet. So like a lot of people, like they always give me that joke because when you go get fast food, I order a diet, and they're like, oh, what diet? I'm like, I actually like the taste of diet better than.
I do too. It's not about the calories. I don't like the sweetness. Yeah. I don't like the aggressive sweetness of regular soda.
But, okay, guys, let's get out of here.
All right.
We've been running a long time. Yeah, guys, thanks for joining us. I hope you enjoyed the show for whatever the show was. Let ups
There's
and
a
downs.
Lot of things.
Yeah, we covered a lot. We don't even have a topic for this week. It's episode 10. That's the show title.
Yep.
There's no title for this show.
New Year's downer.
Yeah, I hope we had a good time. If you're listening, if you're listening in the replay, hope you enjoy it, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel on iTunes or Google Play. We say it every week, but please do so. Please give it a star rating and leave a review if you'd like. It helps us a bunch. Like Bangs always says, we don't know how, but it does. So please subscribe. Again, it's like follow on Twitch. It's not, when I say subscription, it's not like a Twitch subscription. You're not paying. It's just a follow.
Yeah. Follow guys, us on iTunes.
Or yeah, and iTunes, please. Google Play, please. It helps us a lot. Any last words you guys want to say?
Next week, we're not even pretending that we have a topic. We're just going to have a, we're just going to chat next week. And so if you're listening to the show, not live, if you're watching it on YouTube or VOD, or you're listening to it on iTunes or Google Play, I encourage you to be here live next week. Because I'm going to volunteer us. We don't have a topic next week. We're just going to have a chat, which is basically what the show is these days. But I think we're ideally going to include more of the live viewers for that conversation as well. So I encourage you to be here live next week for the show.
That's new to me.
Yep.
It is just new to everybody. I just decided that right now.
TV/Vinny Bag of Donuts.
Yes. Give that man a follow, but mostly give me a follow because I'm a whore.
I don't need
anyone who's watching us live is watching us.
Yeah, fuck Mr. Christopher. He's a piece of shit.
Yeah, I wish we were.
Fucking watches my stream and then decides he's going to stream himself and then he overshadows me.
I wish we went to a different direction with that one.
What?
Oh, what? With next week?
What? What? No, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Next week? Wait, in a different direction?
No, I was talking about Chris. I was running a joke.
Oh, different direction with me.
Oh.
Because you don't want me to be on your show anymore.
We need you at this point. That's the part that depresses us. Also, you know what? I'm going to go ahead. I want to plug the show for the week after that because I think that's going to be a big show. The 13th is the big Switch event, and we're going to talk about it that night. And I think there's going to be a lot. I'm hoping that Nintendo gives us some information. You know, and it was our first show, so it wasn't our best show, but it was definitely one of our more interesting shows. I'm really excited for the Nintendo Switch, so I'm really excited for that press event. And so I'm really excited for the show on the 13th talking about the Switch.
Yeah, it should be good. Let's see what happens. Hey, if it's good enough and it announces it, maybe I'll fucking even pre-order on the 13th.
I'm hoping at this point I'm a first day buyer. I just don't want them to do anything to make me change my mind.
Honestly, the only reason I'd be a first day buyer is for Twitch, unless depending on what the launch titles are. I don't want to buy a console just for fucking Zelda.
You're a pussy.
Yeah, Zelda probably is not enough for me, but if there's a Mario to go with it or something along those lines, I'd probably buy it.
If I was streaming on Twitch, I wouldn't be a first day thing. A Switch giveaway. You know what's funny? John, who is one of is my biggest supporters and has helped me. If you guys are a day oneer from the stream, you know who John is. He's helped us a lot. He didn't know how Twitch worked, and he said if I became partner by the time the Switch got released, that he would do a if I became partnered by then, he would do a Switch console giveaway on my channel. Little does he know that's not how it works. Granted, it could be how it works because I've been streaming just as long as some recent partnerships, which really makes me feel like I'm a bad streamer. But again, that might go back to some of my other points I made, not to do whatever, but that was kind of funny. He was like, yeah, he was in chat one day, he's like, yeah, I'm gonna give away John does good for himself, and he was like, yeah, you know, because he's my number one supporter in this, and he was like, yeah, once Vinny gets partnered, I'm gonna give away a Nintendo Switch live on stream. And yeah, that's not gonna happen, but I was just reading. Oh, I said that only because Stacy, I'm sorry, I'm responding to Stacy in chat, who said a Switch giveaway. If anything, I'm gonna sucker you guys into buying me a Nintendo Switch.
I had disillusions of doing a giveaway of the NES Classic, but I didn't know they were going to be so fucking hard to get a hold of.
Yeah, I was going to
do
a couple.
When I got one, you know, and I almost flipped it on eBay for $400, I'm like, fuck, you can have it for that price, but
you should have.
I should have, but I kept it.
That was another thing. If it was easy, John was going to do giveaways with that, but then right when that came out was when my stream started fluttering, so.
Yeah, I hear you.
Because we were growing at a steady rate, and then
yeah,
for whatever different reasons, it's been tail spinning. It's been loop de looping.
I made a comment in a partnered streamer stream, just sort of offhand. I said, well, I was making a statement. I was, you know, and I said, oh, wow, you've come so far in only a year. And they corrected me that it was only 8 months. And for a moment, I was kind of like, go fuck yourself, dude. Like, just let it ride. All right. It took you a year. Fuck.
I hear you. Yeah. All right, boys. We ready?
Yep, we're ready. Let's
we set our final thoughts. We can keep going because that's what we do. We yenta. Guys, thanks for joining us. I had a blast. I already said the goodbyes, but for Mr. Christopher, Bangs, Michael, and myself, have a safe and happy New Year's. May it be a good one. May you get some New Year's kisses, maybe a little New Year's finger blint banging. Who knows? Good night, guys.
Peace, love.